Yo, it's the Mystery School stream on a Friday. Question marks in the chat.
Yeah, please. Chat them up.
Charge them up. Chat them up.
You know what it is. It's Friday, the last stream of the week. So that obviously opens you up for a Freestyle Friday today. Every 5 gifted subs gets a cursed freestyle of your choice. We don't know what it'll be. We don't know what the topics are. You pick them. We just here to deliver. Freestyle Friday underway right now. We also got our sub goal in the corner there for tonight's sudden death unlock. Every sub tonight goes towards the unlock goal, so it all goes for a good cause. Thank you to Command Sheriff, DX13 Primo. We had a couple other gifted subs while we were loading up.
We got
In Love We Trust.
In Love We Trust with the 8-month resub. Young General So with the gifted sub to Tick the West. DX13 Primo and Command Sheriff. Thank you both for the prime sub. Welcome back,
That's
everyone.
Right.
60 subs tonight for the sudden death. We got plenty of fire articles, including tonight's title article, which many of you may have already seen. It's going to be a good stream tonight.
That's right, man. News is busting tonight. Specifically, Nick Cannon did a thing, man. And I know he busts a lot, but this time it's not him busting.
He busts
Nick
a lot.
Nick Cannon doing another thing. There's a bunch of... A dog got discriminated against for a reason that I won't tell you, but there's dog discrimination going down. All that and more in tonight's news segment coming up in a little bit. If you ever want to dedicate or donate us some news, go ahead and drop it in the stream news section of the Discord. That would help us out a lot. And as of late, we also accept tweets, random memes, falsified articles, articles that are pure disingenuous information. We accept all of that. So just dump them in the stream news section of the Discord.
We are especially excited about disinformation on the stream lately.
Yes. Love the good disinformation, so all that is fair game for us. Drop us some news. We'd love to do a sudden death about it or possibly just laugh at it, you know, as a family.
All right. It's the footwork mix. Let's go.
That's fucking tight. Who got in the chat today, man? Taylor Jane, Ari Flux, Markov in here, First Nation. The Kringle said Ular Dalam Pesawa.
Oh, yeah.
He got a snake in
there. Danny Grandeur said Pesawa. Good chat.
Let's go, man. Yeah, maybe we'll make the Pesawat varsity jacket.
Yes.
Snake-covered jacket.
Welcome back, everyone. Uh-oh, I hope this works.
Ah, shit.
Hold on.
There it is, the death. Anyway, it's Freestyle Friday, y'all. You know the rules. Every 5 gifted, every 5 of them get you a freestyle of your choice. Or you could request that I just shut the fuck up.
Damn, 5 gifted subs to shut the fuck up? Friday?
It works. Either way, man, I'm a flexible guy.
We haven't brought back Shut the Fuck Up Friday in a while, dude.
Yeah, I know. I've been feeling like real talkative since 2022, man.
Yeah, same.
I don't know. I haven't been really ready to shut the fuck up just yet. But don't you worry, because I will in a moment's notice. I'll shut the fuck up and have you guys join me.
We'll do it instantly. It's fine. Silent subs. Nastilla says, damn, so ain't nobody going to gift your boy a sub?
Ooh, Nastilla.
Buck naked in the streets right now.
Yeah, you got to get some grease, man. Make yourself enticing. Grease yourself up and, you know, get yourself a little Intamin's preview window so they can see what they're purchasing before they give you a sub.
Young General So.
Let's go.
With the 5 gifted.
Big General So. Appreciate that.
Holding us down, man. Just made me switch up the mix. I got to find a beat to play right now. What's your request for a topic?
Let us know that topic request, General So, while Owen finds the beat. And we'll get ready to start our first freestyle of the night for Freestyle Goddamn Friday.
Rap using your inside voice like you're in the library.
Oh, no problem.
Okay, I got you. Here you go.
Oh, yeah, this is giving me a lot of anxiety. Yeah. Hey, can you guys hear me out there? Everything all right? Yeah. Check it. Hey, excuse me. Do you have any more cough drops? I don't want to cough in here. That'll make my heart stop. If it gets too loud, then just let me know. Tap me on the shoulder. Tell me where I need to go. I'm getting escorted out by security. I hope they don't hit me with their nightsticks. I'm fearing thee. They're quite scary, quite hairy. I'm quiet like the mother of that horror movie, Carrie. She's scary as shit. A lot of children in this library, and they're scary as shit too. I'm 6'2". And the bathroom smells like shit poo. Ah, I should probably alert the janitor. But I'm not the man to do that. I'm standing up. I grabbed my hands across the banister, did a little dance, and spit in a canister. I grabbed it because it's phallic shaped. I like that. I have dinner about 7:45 every single night, and every single light inside of my house, it just went out. I called my landlord, asked for some repair tips, and he said, "Hey, you're too loud over there, bitch." I tried to quiet it down and get a little bit more lower on the decibels, but I fucked up my decimals. This is a quiet freestyle. This is a quiet place. I hit a pee style. That's a style of pissing where you do a little design. I ain't sneak dissing.
Oh, shit.
Let's go.
It's the quiet freestyle on Freestyle Friday. We already got two freestyles lined up.
Shut the fuck up. Friday is underway with the first quiet freestyle in history.
In Love We Trust with Five Gifted. Mobs with Five Gifted as well.
Oh, shit.
In Love We Trust, what are you feeling? What do you need from us tonight?
Am I still quiet?
I am sneak dissing. I'm quiet pissing. That's a style of peeing.
In Love We Trust, what do you want? Let us know.
Give me that bad haircut freestyle. I got you.
All right.
I had some bad haircuts in my life. I can relate.
Mobs, you're up next.
Shit. Fuck. Yeah. It's Freestyle Friday. Shut the fuck up out there. Shit. Yeah. I just left the barber shop. I hopped out of the chair. I put my hand over the top of my hair, and half of it was gone. It felt like a fucking thong. There was a line going right through the middle of my shit. I tell the bartender, the barber, suck a dick. He said, "Oh, my bad, I ain't mean to do you like this." But you did. Now I gotta go see my kids, and they gonna roast me. Cause I'm looking like a roach, G. I'm looking ghostly. I might as well die. I live in the barber shop since I was like 5. And this the worst cut I got. It looked like somebody grabbed the Graham Brothers cock and rubbed it in the clippers. It looks so crazy. I'm about to grab the clipper, pull it out and shoot. I'm about to grab the blicker. The blicker ton. I got a ton of time to think about what the fuck is on my fucking scalp. Nothing. It looked like somebody just caught a muffin and then grounded the crumbs up into my hair. Hairline looking like somebody rubbed it with some Nair. Nair removes all your knee hairs. Damn. Fuck around and see bears with this cut. That shit is fucked up. Almost walked into a butt. Cause I don't care about my life no more. My hair cut so fucked up, I wanna die in the store.
Oh!
Yeah, yeah.
Freestyle Friday.
It's Freestyle Friday.
We already got two more freestyle requests from Great Dane and Megan Maxine. Thank you both for the five gifted. Mobs is up next. Mobs, what kind of freestyle you want?
That's what's up. What's the next topic, man? Freestyle Friday underway. Shut up. Shut the fuck up. It's time, man. All right. Mobs topic, you up next. I don't know if you dropped it already. I'm trying to scroll through the chat and find it. Okay, Mob says, box of pasta falls out of the grocery bag, but your hands are really full of groceries. But two trips are for bitches, so you can't bend down and grab it and you're on a flight of stairs. Gotcha.
Damn, okay.
Say less.
Here you go.
Say less. What? Whoa, 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 whoa. I'm not trying to play the whole fucking fool. I just came in from a trip to Whole Foods. Yeah, that shit was so cool. All types of organic shit. I grabbed a lot of it, put it in a bunch of bags, but I'm about to body it. I got home, put a bunch of bags on my pinky, and they're wearing it down. It's all painful. It's about to make me die, turn to an angel. I'm at the top of the flight, the stairs looking slight. I look down to the left, then I look to my right. No neighbors to help. Nobody gave a fucking hair. Nobody cared. I wouldn't even dare walk down the stairs without grabbing both handles. I grabbed a lot of them, then pop with my candles. They fell out the bottom. There's a hole in the bag. So now I'm carrying one empty bag, waving it like a white flag. I surrender, man, I quit. My life sucks dick, this is bullshit. Yeah, and my pinky on the other hand just broke too, cause that's where I was holding all the canned foods from Whole Foods.
Damn.
And they heavier, they weigh a fucking lot. I got a 2 liter of some pop, and I got a Glock in the same bag. Yeah, I might have bought it from the Whole Foods guy that just got audited. Yeah, he don't give a fuck about his job no more, so he sold me a Glock right out of the side door at the store that he worked at. I'm about to grab a brown bag and twerk that.
Damn.
Yeah.
Freestyle Friday. Freestyle Friday. Dude, the freestyle requests are lining up. You're going
it's
too hard
stopping.
Today.
You're going
we
too
ain't
hard.
Stopping. We in the mix
we
right now.
We got Kix LaFlair and Damob with 5 gifted subs as well. Thank you, guys.
Big salute.
Up next is Megan Maxine. Megan Maxine.
Big salute right
what
there.
What topic do you want? What are you feeling? Holy shit. He's going crazy today.
All right. Let me see. Who got a topic for us in the chat? Throw it in there, man. Just got audited. Yeah.
Damn, the Whole Foods man didn't give a fuck about his job anymore.
Audit that fucker,
sold
man.
Sold you the blower out of the side door.
Selling the blick outside of the Foods door, man. That's crazy. All right. Listen to. Kix LaFlair, what you got? Listen to. I think that was who was next.
Oh, no, we got Megan Maxine, Great Dane, Kix, and Damob.
Damn, now those all flew in at the same time.
I think we got to cap the freestyles here.
All right, so let's see. We got... All right, we'll come back to Megan. Who was after Megan? It was Dumob?
Great Dane 22.
Great Dane, what's the topic, man? You give me a topic. I'm freestyling about it right now. It's Freestyle Friday. Tying your sneakers too tight? All right, I'll take that one. I'll definitely take that to this sexy beat.
Oh, yeah.
Check it. Yeah, it's 8:30 on the dot. I just grabbed my Reeboks, tied them up real tight. Blood circulation light. It's not going right. It hurts real bad when I walk and my toe turned to ice. I can't feel it, man. It's going numb. I got my ankles tied to the fucking top. I'm going fucking dumb. You know the rules. I walked into the high school. They looked down and said, what are those, dude? Then they said, man, my shit was tied tight as shit. And my ankles feel like a brick because the circulation's stopping. But I'm not rocking. You got a problem with me? Just consider another option. Because I run super fast when my shoes tied up. I run through the glass. Yeah, in a gun, I shoot it fast. Because they give me more speed when they're laced up. Yeah, I might not be a fashion symbol, but I'm safe, bruh. Fuck you. I ain't no fashion icon. But I guarantee I won't trip because my shoes are on. And they tied. Tight as shit. Ankle feeling like somebody grabbed some dynamite and ignited
Damn.
It. Little bitch.
Let's keep it moving. We got more freestyles to get
We
through.
Got more. 17. Oh, God. Yo. We got a couple minutes before the DJ mix is over.
Great Dane already hit you with the next topic. You hear a noise and your dog just ran out the door and you got to chase his ass looking all goofy and shit.
Oh, damn. Okay. Got it. That sounds good. Yeah, fucking dog. Yeah, check it. Yeah, yo. So I came from the shelter and I brought this little bitch home. His name's Bitchbone. I called him. He's just home for the first time. He used to live outside. He used to drink rainwater from gutters and shit. He used to drink out of little puddles. He stinks. He's got a little stench. I gave him a bath. He walked into the house. I caved in fast. I gave him a treat. And he told me don't tweak. He ran out the fucking door and then he creeped. Another cat ran across the fucking street with him. I'm not gonna be a victim. Neighbors looking at me silly because I just rolled a Philly and I had it in my ear tucked. I seen a deer, a duck, a fucking hockey puck, and a cuck. As I chased my dog up the street looking for him before we switch feet. Before we switch meat, I'ma throw this on the grill. My little dog's name is Shih Tzu and a pill. He took one. He found a loose pill in my pocket. He ate that bitch and then he took off like a rocket.
Damn.
He's a fast little Shih Tzu. And I wonder what the shit do or where he's gonna shit shoes. Is my neighbor gonna call the cops? Is he gonna bite one of their children and then I got a fucking box? Cause their dad's like, hey, that dog bit my Sally. She like 3 years old. You gonna go to Bally's? That's total fitness. Working like a gymnast. Eating fucking Slim Jims in a thin vest.
Oh, shit. It's Freestyle Friday. We got two left. Kix, what do you want, man?
I can't stop it.
What was the line about switching meat?
Switch the meats, you know. Just throw a different meat on the grill.
All right. We got Kix and Damob. Let us know what freestyles you want, and then we're going to start the show.
Hockey puck, fucking cuck, etc.
Cuck. Yeah. And I saw a cuck.
I knew he was a cuck just by the way he looked. All right, we got the next topic up here. Kix LaFlair said, fighting in a tournament with fighting game characters. All right, okay, this is the real shit right here. Yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, it's time for tourney. You know what's going on. I'm not taking no paternity test. I know my son. He's 6 years old. And I don't give him money, but when he calls me up, I go off and running. I take it, I run. I grab a fucking controller, then I break it. A gun, I might need that if I get naked. A nun, she told me to pray. And then I grab a Sega controller and told her to play. Look, bitch, you know what this is. I'm a fighting game character. I'm kicking them kids. I'm kicking kids in their liver. Get a sliver of respect if you break another fucker's neck.
Damn.
You know me. I'm going Liu Kang. I'm doing bicycle kicks through a window pane.
Damn.
I drop kick like I'm Hulk Hogan, World of the Wars, and I'm grabbing folding chairs. Hit him in his hair. Split him like some hairs. I got venomous hairs and venomous tears in my skin, and I bend like Ken. And Ryu, you can sneeze at you. Oh, they don't respect me because I'm fat like Kirby. Small little dude, hairy as shit like a Furby.
Damn.
Yeah, you can't slur me. I don't succumb to fucking insults from none of you bums.
Damn.
You know? Oh, yeah, he tried to disrespect me. Then I dropped low and gave him a little sweep kick. A little sweet dick will make you feel real nice. But that's okay. If you don't, you'll pay my price. It's cool. It's a low fee. Uppercut him in his chin. I'm like Scorpion running through a bunch of men's. But not sexually. It's all platonic. They cool. I'm like Conker's bad fur day. Fucking squirrel trying to get his girl paid,
damn,
man.
Oh, it's Freestyle Friday. It's all platonic.
Yeah, man. We're just boys. We're just buds.
Oh,
we're just having a good old time as guys, man.
All right, final freestyle. Come on. What are you looking for, man? Damn. These are some high-tier freestyles. Dumb Mob says, end it with a gibberish freestyle.
Oh, shit.
Oh, one right. of my favorites.
Let's see what we got for him. A little jibber jabber. Oh, shit. He said, what?
Oh, shit.
Jibberlickle butt?
Yeah.
Coming in with a cut? Oh, I'm getting stuck in a rut. I grabbed a little meter. I grabbed somebody by the neck and said, skeeter, skeeter. That's my main nigga, Peter. You know, I'm about the jitter leaker.
Yeah.
You know me. I grabbed a beaker from the science store, poured some little acid in it. Then I'm trying to find some more. Krilly Krolic got me feeling brolic. About to smoke some chronic. About to get a Donic. That's a membership to Dominix. Fuck that. I'm about to go and have some drama sex. That means sex is dramatic. Bliggly, bliggly, bliggly. I'm about the rabbits. I got the rabies. You know me, baby. Come on. I'm about to get paid like 80 bucks to go ride around in old lady Mercedes trucks.
Yeah.
And then she said, hey, young man, Klaby Glove. I'm like, Klaby Glove? What the fuck that means? She said, blip, 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 dip, tapping in a spleen. I was like, goddamn, bitch, you Goldeen? And she tried to give me neck, and I was like, no meme. No, ma'am, I don't need that ham. You can back that shit back. I'm about to criminally slam. That shit hurts. You can hurt your elbow. Criminally slamming on the fucking concrete without a bolt. You need some fucking pads on. I'm trying to do the same shit that I put my dad on, man. Put him on a scam. He told me, son, this is a great scam. You're a great man. We should shake hands.
Damn.
I was like, whoa, Dad, that's really nice of you, but I'm about to go and buy a couple bicycle blues.
Yeah.
Some bicycle blues? That means blue bicycles? I'm going to fight in the nude? Damn, that's fucked up.
Holy shit, man.
That's
Come
fucked
on.
Up. I hate my life so much.
Oh, man, that today's Freestyle Friday brought a tear to my eye, man. I'm not going to lie. That was just such beautiful potent lyrics.
Alex Coy with the Beast Come Blues in the chat.
There were so many quotables from the gibberish freestyle,
man,
dude.
Real metaphors.
I cannot
you fucking
believe
kidding
it.
Me?
Oh, God. All right.
Lyrical, spiritual,
Everyone,
miracles.
Everyone, thank you for gifting subs to enable these cursed freestyles. Oh, my God.
We appreciate it. We appreciate it. That's
all right. The only thing left to do. Computer.
Yo.
Start the show.
Let's fucking go.
You're watching Mystery School, the first late night show on the net, with your hosts, Owen Bones and Tony B. Jr. Let's begin.
Yes, It's true. It's the Mystery School stream on a Friday. Can we please have some question marks or Mystery School Union emotes in the chat?
Sprinkle them down. Sprinkle them in that chat. It's the last stream of the week.
Yes.
It could be the last stream of eternity, you know?
You never
so we
know.
Gotta cherish this. Let's cherish this Friday yeah. stream and let's have a good time.
Yeah, tell
man.
Your,
let's get it started.
You never know when life will be suddenly cut short, so tell your Mystery School stream in your life that you love it. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Make sure to let them know. Gingerly Newman, thank you for the 18-month resub. Taylor Jane the Great with 5-month resub as well.
Let's
thank
go.
You both. Thank you everyone who gifted for tonight's Freestyle Friday. We appreciate that. Now we're somehow only 15 subs away from tonight's Sudden Death.
Damn.
If you're new here on the show, Sudden Death is a segment where we make a full song live in under 30 minutes, and you pick the topic based on all the shit we're going to talk about tonight for the news, and oh boy, there is a lot of it.
Technically, there's shit tonight. There is literal shit tonight coming up on the news.
Great Dane, on one hand, says, the apocalypse is upon us. And Chubsy Wubsy underneath him says, Owen, I'm trying not to have an existential crisis. Please don't say that. Don't worry. The Mystery School stream and all of your loved ones will be around indefinitely.
Forever. Mm-hmm. Forever.
And ever.
All right, we got a great show lined up tonight. I have a good feeling about this one. I've got a very nice feeling about the show. Markov with the 19-month resub. Please take this subscription to war.
Oh.
We'll bring it with us and keep it in a small locket that we look at in the front lines, Markov. We promise.
Will my Mystery School sub ever return home from the war?
Damn. All right, we got the news coming up in just a second. And, of course, we got letters from the class happening right now.
Oh, letters from the class.
We didn't really plug that hard today. Forgot about that. If you want your question, comment, or concern answered live on stream, consider heading to the Mystery School Discord and going to the letters from the class section and writing something in. We'll answer them in real time as they're coming in right now.
Yes, yes, yes. Write us something cool, clever, or just concerning. We're good with it all.
Mm-hmm,
I guess I can kick it off here. I see one right off bat that I definitely need to dive into here. This is from an anonymous author. It just simply says, what's the weirdest gift you ever received?
The weirdest gift?
Weirdest gift you ever received.
Ever of all time? My homie Wilson, shout out to Wilson. He sometimes watches the stream. He transferred into my grade school in like third grade, I believe. And it was the first day of school. And he was sat next to me in the class. And he was just like, hey, what's your name, Mom? And I was like, oh, I'm Owen. I introduced myself to him. And he was like, do you want this? And he had a rabbit's foot. And I was like, oh.
Was it like raw or the clean one?
It was
that
a
are
clean
like
one.
A keychain.
But it was
one.
Like a real, it seemed like a real rabbit's foot. And I was like, oh, thank you. I was like in third grade, you know, like I didn't really know what it meant or it was lucky or anything. I was like, oh. Thanks,
oh, thank
man.
You,
you know?
Sir.
And I had it, and I was just, like, thinking about it all day. Like, I don't know what to do with it. Like, is it disrespectful to, like, not do something with it? Like, I don't know. And then at the end of the day, he came back up to me and was like, actually, can I have that back? And I was like, actually, yeah, dude, no hard feelings. I don't really know what to do with it, so it's fine. It was a good gift, but a very strange gift.
Yeah. Man, I can't say that this is the weirdest gift I've ever received, but definitely the most disappointing gift I ever received. This was about I want to say like second grade. I want to say like second to third grade. I was still a young child, but my grandma, God bless her soul, she really wanted to get me something cool for Christmas, and I remember telling my mom like, man, yeah, man, you know. The White Ranger, you know, Power Rangers, you know, White Ranger's really cool. You know, if you guys can get me the walk around Zord where it's like his own Megazord that used to walk with the remote and do all that stuff. I was like, that might be cool if you guys can swing that for your boy. And my grandma was like, oh, yeah, sure. Okay. Yep. We'll get it. And I guess my mom was supposed to like be instructing her as to what that was or how to find that and didn't and ended up leaving my grandma to her own devices.
Uh-oh.
And my grandma came back. I'll never forget it. She came back with something called a riding force. It was like it was somewhat similar to like what a Power Ranger was.
Right.
I guess the concept
it was
of
like
a human
an action guy.
There was a human there for sure. It was a human character, I guess. But the thing about riding force was they didn't stay together intact very long. So.
Right.
by the time I got it, there were different like pieces, like paint chipping off of the thing. And he had a button on the back of his head that used to make his eyes light up, and then he screamed. He just,
God.
He didn't like say, oh, attack or Power Rangers. He just said, oh,
oh, shit.
Oh, every time he pressed the button. And I was just like, okay, thanks, Grandma.
Thanks, Grandma.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
That was it.
Wow, well, shout out to Riding Force, it was called.
Riding Force was the name of that. I'll never forget that.
Shout out to Riding Force. We appreciate that.
Yeah.
Also, the Stone Collie, welcome back for 3 months. Aloxta, welcome back for 16 months. And Charlie Torque with a gifted sub. Thank you all. We appreciate that. My dog Jeff says, kill me.
I think that's what he uses. Like,
murder me. Murder me. Don't like living.
He was a screamer. All right, I got a question here from Anonymous. Anonymous asks, when's the last time you said fuck you to somebody? How'd you feel? I said fuck you to someone in traffic, like maybe a month ago, and I regretted it, man. Like, it's really hard to make me upset. I'm a very even keel guy. I'm very conflict avoidant, but I was having a very bad day, and I think they saw me say fuck you to them, and they just looked kind of disappointed, you know? They looked like I hurt their feelings, and I was like, oh. And I felt kind of bad, honestly.
Oh. Well,
kind of bad.
I say fuck you to a lot of people in traffic usually. No remorse, though. I do not feel any remorse because fuck them, man. They did something stupid. It's a
they
fuck
did
you,
do
dude.
Something really stupid.
It's dangerous. Like, you could have killed us all, man. Like, sometimes it's fuck you to people in traffic.
Right.
Like, you could have murdered everybody.
Yeah.
But personally, the last time I said fuck you specifically to somebody, fuck you. Damn, when did I say fuck you to somebody? I feel like I was angry for sure. I want to say it was recently at a grocery store. Oh, Meijer. It was recently at Meijer, the grocery store.
A good fuck you location.
A good fuck you spot. And the best fuck you spot is at the self-checkout, because you're letting people self-govern, and that's never a good idea. So I'm at the self-checkout. I got a bottle of wine, so I got to get the ID checked from the little security guy or whatever, so he can see I'm 21. As I'm waiting for him, there's a light blinking on my shit, you know, on my little register. And then the one guy who's just waiting to get up to the register next, he just sees me standing there, and he's just like, he's an old ass dude. And he's like, well, are you going to check out there or what? And I was like, don't you see the lights on? I'm waiting for somebody. He's waiting for, what are you waiting for? And I was like, I got to get my ID to show this guy. Like, dude, like, just go to another one. Like, there's six other fucking registers here. And he just ended up just asking me, like, when I would be done, and like, are you almost finished, or can I get that? And I was like, dude, I just told you what I'm doing here. And then eventually he walked up to the one next to me, the stall next to me, and put his shit down and started scanning. Then he just looked over at me and was like, wish I could have got this one quicker if you would have had it figured out already. And I was like, have you ever been to a fucking grocery store, my dude? Like, fuck you, man.
And you let out a fuck you.
Yeah. I was like, fuck you, man.
Yeah.
Like, a grocery store is literally where people wait in line to do things. Like, why are you so confused as to how this works?
That makes sense. Yeah. Dude, I have a suggestion for the last question of the day. I read the first two sentences of this, and then I realized we should just read the rest live. Go to 1375.
I'm there.
All right.
It's in all caps. I see it.
Let's check this one out. You want to read this one dramatically for us here?
I can do that. Yes. Let's get the right voice for this.
One time when I was a freshman, I was on a plane sitting next to a single mom and her young son. Mama was stressed and tired of her son's shit. He kept acting a fool, jumping up in his seat. I peeped she was trying to sleep, so I told the boy, young man, sit down. He ignored me. This went on for a while, and I lightly punched him in the chest. I lightly punched him in the chest. It was really a light tap on God. He fell down into his seat and he looked at me, then started crying. I quickly pressed play on my iPod and was acting like I was listening to Miss Me by Drake the whole time. Mom woke up, son said I hit him. I look like, I don't know what he's talking about. And she went back to sleep.
That's the end of the submission. Not a question.
Just
a confession,
a chaotic phrase. A chaotic combination of random letters and words right there.
Oh, shit.
I wish you would have announced who you were with that one. You assaulted another person's child in broad daylight, mask off.
Lightly.
A light assault.
In the chest.
Literal light assault right there.
You just gave him across the aisle.
It did like a one punch man, like a one of those punches that you don't really go anywhere. You just kind of like lean into them. Like,
oh, shit. Grish Mapolitan says, no, don't snitch on yourself. Yeah, it may be within the statute of limitations here, so don't tell us who you were in the chat.
That's called a duff, LOL. Yeah, you duffed a random kid. That's fucked up.
Oh, my God.
Honestly, though, you might be a hero, man. I think more random kids need to get punched in the chest by strangers.
Especially
sometimes.
On airplanes, dude. Those random kids don't know what the hell's going on, and, you know, the parents aren't going to do anything about it, so.
Yeah, sometimes a random stranger should punch your kids in the chest.
Yeah, the airline attendant should be legally allowed to give your children a light chest punch, you know?
I feel like back in the day, airline flight attendants were legally able to like spank your child on the plane mid-flight.
Yo, what is this? Can we get Herman Grant, Tony, Tiny Tony copypasta the chat? This is what they're posting in chat. You see what I just put in there? Fuck you.
Old man, fuck you. Yeah. Yeah, dude. I go to Meijer a lot, and it's definitely Midwest old guy heaven, man. It's a lot of fisherman gear
that,
and just hats.
That and like a Jewel. Like a Jewel or a Meijer. Yeah. Or like where you find a 67-year-old Gulf War veteran, like disheveled
it's
and confused.
A just confused vet. thank you guys for your service,
you
by
your
the
service.
Way, everybody. But it's just always a confused vet in there just fucking tripping, man, and holding up the line.
Yeah, for real.
So shout out Meijer for knowing their demographic at least, you know.
It's true. All right, now that we've established when's the last time that we were sent into a violent rage in real life and one of our viewers punched a child in the chest on an airplane, I think we can start the news today.
Let's squeak through that news, man. It's about that time.
Unfortunately, things are not going to get any... Well, fortunately, if you're into chaos, things are going to only get weirder from here. So let's just start it off with a nice video that was submitted by our viewers in the stream news section here.
I'm all about the snickle. You take a snicker and put it in the middle of a pickle.
Yeah.
I think I might be the snickle eating champion. I did this on my radio show. I've eaten lots of snickles.
People love it.
Yeah, is it what y'all all know? This is good, y'all.
Humans?
Huh?
Oh. Look at the old lady's like, I'll still fuck him right now.
I will fuck him.
I'll still fuck that young man.
Yeah, he put the snickers in the pickle and he took a gulp.
A pickle or a... Wait. Oh, no, I was about to say pickers, but that sounds like another... That sounds like a Rogan word, man. I won't say that
Big
again.
Big Baby Seth says, with perfect grammar and an exclamation mark at the end, I hate this.
This is worse than pilk, hip-hop monster.
This don't make you sterile, says Ray J. Hey, dude, I don't know, man. I mean, Nick Cannon is not sterile. So
no, he's very furt.
Very furt.
He's extremely furt.
Snickle-eating champ.
Anybody in the chat? How y'all feeling about the snipple?
Why did Tim Kilm say Nick has perpetual pregnancy cravings by proxy?
Yes,
he's just tapped in with all of the baby moms in the world.
Look, he's even eating pregnant food, like putting a Snickers and a pickle together. That's a very I'm pregnant type of combination right there.
Nick Cannon is my mortal enemy for this and many other reasons, says Lame James.
Good Lord, man.
Not much to really extrapolate on there, honestly. Just... Nick Cannon eating a Snickers in a pickle.
If you're looking for a wet, uncomfortable shit at the end of the night, go ahead and buy yourself some snipples or pickle Snickers.
I do like the close-up on it as well. Look at this. You can see it just glistening. Like, you know those were fresh out of the jar, steel-coated in the pickle embryonic fluid, and sliced open right on time for the show to go live.
Ah, man. Well... There it is. I learn something new about Nick Cannon every day, and I don't know if I need to.
Oh, no. Ari Flux with the classic copypasta. I saw Tony Reed Jr. to Meijer in Chicago yesterday. I told him how cool it was to meet him in person, but I didn't want to be a douche and bother him and ask him for a photo or anything. He said, oh, like you're doing now? I was taken aback. All I could say is, huh? But he kept cutting me off and going, huh, and kept closing his hand shut in front of my face. I walked away and continued with my shopping as I heard him chuckle as I walked off.
Wow. Yeah, stay out of Meijer then, and don't bother me while I'm shopping.
It's that easy, you know?
Leave me alone while I'm doing my Meijer shopping.
It's that easy. That's a great copypasta. Thank you. Adriana says he would say that. Wow.
He would.
Damn, he would say that. Tony, a villain. Has experienced that or not?
Let me Meijer in peace, you know?
Yeah, for real. Well, any closing comments about the pickle sliced open with a Snickers in between? Wait, actually, I have a comment. Is it true that they got rid of the dick vein, like the throbbing vein down the center of the Snickers?
Oh, no. I would stop eating Snickers if they were just smooth without that vein, man. Like, yeah. I think that's half the fun of a Snickers is
right.
Just looking at how much it resembles a muscle dick, bro. Like, that shit is the most dick-like candy I have ever seen in my life. But, God, is it the best? It's the most delicious candy that exists.
Yeah, I mean, my Snickers bar doesn't have a vein. Oh, shit. Nah. Chat, okay, this may be hard for some of you to hear. I'm sorry to have to tell you this way. Snickers to remove big dick vein energy from chocolate bars following green M&M being called out for her promiscuity.
No, I won't fucking, I won't take this. I will boycott. I'll petition. I'll sign a goddamn, whatever those forms are when you ask everybody to agree.
Yeah.
A petition probably. Yes. But don't take away what makes Snickers Snickers. Yeah. And that's the cock vein.
That's the dick vein on the top of the Snickers. Although this one looks a bit different. It looks a little more like a manta ray. Sometimes you have those ones that just run from the bottom to the top. Like,
I love those,
up,
man. You know? It's like, it's looking like a shaken forearm of a dick, bro. And Snickers knew what they were doing by creating that.
Knocking says,
this is the future liberals want.
Every Snickers emasculated. No smooth. Throbbing vein.
Smooth Snickers. That'll be disgusting. Just a smooth skin Snickers. You don't want
what
that.
What are we
you
supposed
want
to do
vein.
With that, man? No one asked for this.
That vein helps me keep a good grip so it doesn't slip out of my hands.
It's ergonomic. You know?
You know,
it's more safer like that. This vein has gotten me through some tough times. Sippy rhetoric. Damn. Yeah, sorry, everyone. Snicker you had to learn vein. This way. The Snickers are flaccid now, unfortunately.
Damn, they just cucked Snickers, man. Yeah. This is... When will it stop?
When's the last time you had a Snickers? I think the last time I had a
yesterday.
Snickers. Really?
Yeah, that's why I remember. I was like, it was definitely a dick vein on the Snickers I had yesterday.
Wow. I think it was probably like around like 5 Halloweens ago, a fun-sized one.
Yeah, those are the best, though. Yeah. It's the very, very tiny fun-sized ones. Those are the ones that really hit.
Today, bro, says knocking. anyone eating Snickers within the last 48 hours, please type 1 in the chat. We're trying to harvest data on behalf of Amazon.
R.I.P. to Snicker Dick Vein. Yeah. Hopefully they figure that out.
R.I.P. Hey, listen, even those fun size need the vein, says Gingerly Newman. It's true.
They do have a very small little vein on the fun size one, so
it's
all fair. All
right. Let's keep moving here. We got a little bit more food news to get through today before we get on flexing on poor people news, and then strange animal news. So it's all coming really fast today. Up next, check it out. Mike Tyson is selling weed gummies in the shape of a bitten ear. Man, there is a tier of being, like, a famous rich guy where you can just do, like, a novelty project that has, like, the market cap of someone else's entire multiple business ventures.
Man, yeah, I'm actually really, I'm really impressed with Mike Tyson's, like, business approach, to be honest. Like, this dude went completely broke after boxing was over and shit was bad. And he was like supposed to be like a poor guy. Like they set him up for disaster and he just started to fill in these very niche interests and become a character in them. Like he went to Adult Swim and started doing cartoons, which was fucking hilarious, man. Like I didn't think a Mike Tyson cartoon would be goddamn hilarious, but it's goddamn hilarious. He went to do movies, did a great job in those. Yeah. His podcast is actually tight. Like he is great at a bunch of other shit that, you know, is beyond athleticism, man. So I like to see Mike's, his journey has been a really weird one, but I keep seeing him do better and better, man. And he just seemed like a cool weird old rich guy,
man. And
that's
a particularly respectable thing in any creative field, right? Is like when you quote unquote fall off or fall from peak relevancy and can figure out a way, especially in a different lane or like with a novel approach, to continually stay relevant culturally, to continually make money without everyone hating you. You know, that's pretty impressive, honestly.
Yeah, no, kudos to that, man. Mike Tyson is a OG, man. I really like what he's doing.
There's the edibles, Mike Bites.
Yeah, it's fucking stupid. I get that. It's terrible, but it's Mike Tyson doing the ears, man. Like, it's funny.
He'll make a cool $395,000 from this, probably.
he'll make a modest $395,000 from that, so it's okay.
For the love of Ray J, back for 36 months. Flex 36 like the based god, he says. Ray J, thank you for holding us down. Thank you for being our Mystery School cultural archivist here on the stream. We appreciate you, man.
Thank you.
So, yeah, Mike Tyson, weed gummies. I feel like
he bit the shit out of that man's ear. I forgot about that.
And look, he's going, oh,
God damn it, Mike.
Damn. I bet he's upset about this now that his ear biting pain has been commemorated in a cheeky edible line.
Yeah, or I wonder if he's getting any royalties or any type of percentage.
You gotta give
sales.
Royalties to the guy whose ear you bit. It's only fair.
I mean,
fair.
Copyright, you
right.
know?
It's my, hey, copyright this is an image of my ear that was bit, okay?
Damn. Oh, that's tight. They do got a little chunk bitten out of the ear.
Yeah,
that's
there
cool.
is. It's true.
Wow. Well, again, another smart, weird business move from old Mike Tyson himself.
Yep.
Let's see what he does next.
He's definitely going to make money. We are very confident in that fact. They need to fight again, Charlie Dark.
Salsa Rojas said, ears should be more skin inclusive, skin tone inclusive.
Oh, yeah.
Man, yeah, if they should have made it a brown, like, chocolate ear.
Yeah.
That would have been cool,
right,
too.
A chocolate. Oh, well, dude, that's going to be the next line. They're going to do all sorts of different ears and, like, different flavors and stuff.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. All right. Look at that. Marketing.
Yeah, let's go.
Crazy.
Okay. He ain't streaming a mint. Oh, Bass God. Yeah, anyone been in a Lil B stream lately?
I have not.
Yeah, I definitely have not. All right. What state of mind do you have to be in to chomp someone's ear?
Get
feral fury.
Ass whooped.
Yes.
Pain, man. You probably were too young to remember that fight, but Mike Tyson was getting his... Oh, shit.
Sorry, I accidentally played the next video.
Mike Tyson was getting his ass kicked, man, and he was getting the shit knocked out of him, so he had to do something fast, and unfortunately, it was bite an ear. That's what he had to do.
Yeah, he had to bite. He had to chomp, man. Tommy Shishido with the non-GMO, all-organic, regular sub coming in.
Let's go, Tommy. Thank you.
For the sub. We appreciate that. Usually subs here on the Mystery School stream are forced upon new viewers, but you made the choice yourself. We appreciate that very much, man.
We do.
All right. I legit almost threw my headphones. I'm very sorry about that. Anyway, now everyone's up to enjoy the news segment on the Mystery School stream.
Wake up!
Wake up, everyone.
Fuckers.
It's time. We got some getting fucking flexed on because you're not nearly wealthy enough news here.
My favorite type of news.
It's a Rolls Royce, a futuristic Rolls Royce that will allegedly be released in 2035. This cyberpunk-ass criminal van here.
I know Batman getting wet right now.
Yeah. I don't know, dude. Like, maybe I'm just not highbrow enough. These really crazy concept cars don't do anything to me, especially knowing that they're probably fragile as shit and cost $3 million.
This will never come out.
Also, why'd she come out of this with no drift at all?
Right, we know it's not your car.
Right.
This will never come out. This is such a drastic juxtaposition to like Rolls-Royce's classic style and appearance. Rolls-Royce would never do this. This is too futuristic and opposite of what their style margin is. So they wouldn't do this. Yeah. This is just a concept.
I'm not fucking with it. Is this confirmed that this is actually theirs too? Like,
yeah, it was. It said Rolls-Royce on it. That's kind of, it's fucking weird. It looks like a future Monopoly Man car. Like the Monopoly Man should hop out with a laser or something and be like, there's 33 Skidoo.
And it does have some real Monopoly Man, Batman-esque features. Like she pressed a button and an umbrella came out of the inside of the car. It's like the penguin-ass car. Look. Convenient umbrella ejector in the door of my car.
Rolls Royces, they got that already.
Damn.
They already got that on there.
In the future car, the ye old future car.
This is, it looked like a chariot, man. This is, it's ugly as hell, honestly.
Damn. 1 in 5 Mystery School viewers will have these, says Kixel Flair.
Yeah.
When they become the government mandated car, potentially. I don't know, man. Concept cars don't do much for me.
I would be hitting that on all type of bumps and like curbs and shit and scratching.
And there are so many crevices for dirt and shit to get. Like when the wheel turns, it turns like from inside of a well and like pops out a little bit. You know, all sorts of gunk and roadkill got in there.
Living cats living in there. Like, this is dangerous.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
No, I don't need it. There's just certain things that I would and wouldn't spend $300K on.
Yeah.
And man, I just couldn't do it. Not a Rolls Royce for $300K, man. I'm good. It's a nice thing and nice vehicle. I'm sure it's amazing piece of machinery.
Right.
But no, man, not that. I would buy like the six wheel Benz truck. That right. shit, if I'm going to spend $300K on a vehicle,
on a car.
I'm going to buy some fun shit that I'll actually enjoy to run cats over with.
I'd rather buy two cars with $300,000. You could get like
You could definitely get six cars with $300,000.
You could get like a Tesla Plaid and a G-Wagon for $300,000 as opposed to like one concept car that breaks the second it gets near roadkill.
Yeah, well, that was the Super Rolls Royce from Cyberpunk right there. Yeah. Let us know in the chat if you would pay $300,000 for that, or would you invest in a llama farm or something, you know?
Probably. I hear that shrimp farming is incredibly lucrative if anyone's looking to start a business opportunity, business venture.
Wow.
Let me know. Anyone farming shrimp in their basement, hit me up. Anyway. All right, we got more animal news. Speaking of farming shrimp in your basement, this one is a bit more unfortunate. Dog dumped at local shelter because owners say he's gay.
Oh, my dog. Where my dogs at, man? I already hate regular discrimination. So to discriminate against this dog for his sexual preferences and not give him a home is even more offensive to me.
Rude. Extremely rude. All right. One in the chat, if you would adopt the dog, if you would have you would extend your humble home to the gay dog here. I don't even think that they know. Are dogs gay sometimes?
Dude, honestly, aren't all dogs a little gay? Like, all dogs are a little gay, man. Like, they don't mind doing all types of very homoerotic things to their fellow dog mates. Like, they don't really discriminate. Dogs are kind of like asexual things. They don't really know if they're male or female until it's time to get a red rocket, man.
Will strongly says, dogs be fucking their own brothers. They do not care.
Dogs don't give a shit, man. No. They pretty much fuck whatever's around. I saw my dog fuck his own bed, man. He grabbed his little bed and he rammed it like several times.
Yeah, sometimes dogs just start humping the air. They don't understand what... dogs are fluid in all things. They don't understand this.
Yeah, man. So I find it hard to believe that you can identify any dog's sexual preference because they like everything. They fuck whatever's pretty much around.
Dogs are pansexual, says All Black Zach. I believe it.
Yeah.
They're more advanced is what they are, says Gingerly Newman. Yes, they've broken down all barriers of sexuality. They'll fuck their homie, a random dog they see on the street, a bed, the air, a beanstalk.
A bed. They'll fuck a bed, bro. Like, dogs don't care. There's no way you can just hone in on a dog's sexual preferences by their choices that they give you.
Yeah, man, this is extraordinarily bogus. We do not stand for this here on the
Real
Mystery
School Stream. Real
narrow-minded. A local shelter dog is looking for a soft landing after being dumped by his owners for being gay. I can't believe they were like, oh, hell no, our dog's gay. Take him to the shelter.
Not my dog, not my Rover.
Damn, man, they really went through all the motions to give the dog up because they suspected it might be gay. A Stanley County Animal Shelter Facebook post says the dog's owner surrendered him to the shelter after he humped another male dog. That's normal.
That is literally what you expect out of the first 5 minutes of seeing a dog is for him to go grab another male dog
to
and
hump something.
Hump his ass.
Fezco, the shelter says, is about 4 to 5 years old and weighs 50 pounds. They say he likes people and other animals. The shelter is asking for local rescues to step up and take Fezco into foster before he's adopted. All right, yo, straight up, if you would like to rescue Fezco or know someone who could take him, please call the Stanley County Animal Shelter at 704-986-3881.
Please make this fast, guys. We need to really get Fezco into a deserving home. Yeah. He's not who you think he is. He's not a bad guy, dude. Just because he humped another dog's butt, like...
That's normal.
I think they do that every 10 seconds, man. It's nothing out of the norm of that.
Yeah. Damn, Fezco, I'm sure that he will find a new home sometime soon. But we're sorry to hear about his tribulations in the meantime.
Poor little guy.
Yeah. Shout out Fezco. He's a good dog. Oh, so is Kango. Honestly, probably a W for this dog. Yeah, it's probably for the best he got out of a home where the owners would give him up because they suspected their dog's gay.
Dude, like, if they feel like that about a dog, then what are they doing to humans, man? They're probably a fucking terrible couple of people, man.
Yeah, we're not enthusiastic about that at all. But let's just rock right into this next one without any commentary here. Your dog wouldn't do this to you. Don't do it to them.
Man, PETA gets me a little angry sometimes, man. I'm trying to hold myself back, but,
you know, PETA makes me feel like sometimes you see someone and you're like, ha-ha, they're doing something, like, a little crazy or a little weird, and you're like, ha-ha, oh, yeah, they're being
crazy.
And then sometimes you see someone doing something a little crazy and you're like, like, a little scared, like they might lash out suddenly, you know, at people nearby and around them. That's how I feel about PETA, man. PETA, come on this...
We've extended the invitation to PETA to come on the stream
a while ago, right?
Before, because PETA has actually acknowledged the Mystery School stream several times in the past.
Yes. I just don't know if they're friend or foe, man. They always give me mixed bag of vibes, man. I don't know what's really going on. And this illustration here does not help at all. It appears to be, you know, just a kinky man dragging a lady on a leash right there. That is not a dog in that helmet, for sure.
I don't like that at all. Tip Killams in the chat said,
me and who?
Uh-oh. We're not sure. When's the last time that they interacted with us? It was when we did Fuck SeaWorld Part 2, right?
Yeah, they were like, yep, fuck them, yep, that's like right.
This is great.
You guys aren't wearing leather shoes anymore,
right? They would,
are you?
They would come
we'll
on
throw
the,
blood on
they
you.
Would come in the stream and be like, hey, it's great to be here.
By the way, please read me the tag on your shirt and all nearby jackets.
Yeah,
so it's always just a little too difficult to create a bond with PETA, man. They're very picky, man, so I don't know.
And I mean, their PR strategy has to be, let's do shit like this that makes people like us talk about it to inadvertently spread their message, right? Like, they're not doing this, like, totally, like, oh, no, this is just how we feel. Like, there has to be an element of
self-awareness
to not necessarily just this, but in general. Like, they've said and done so many absurd things that get such massive traction that they seem like the Balenciaga
of animal rights groups,
you know?
Yeah, I think that they for sure are aware. I feel like maybe the first couple times it was just like genuine innocence and like they put up a picture of, like, you know, a fucking furry walking a lady
but
or something
on
accident.
The engagement hit after that first deranged post, and they were like, oh, we're never going back to being reasonable.
Because you got to think, man, it's got to be at least 40 to 50 young Generation Z kids working at PETA through internships and shit. And they read memes. They're still current. So I'm sure they're the ones in charge of the social media. And yeah, they probably thought that shit would be hilarious.
Yeah, their elder millennial boss told the interns, like,
yeah, now draw a weird picture of a furry leading along a girl on a collar and make sure she's redheaded and on her knees.
And they were like, oh, bet. That's going to do numbers. Did it do numbers? Yup. Yeah. They got ratioed.
But that's what they wanted all along.
Yeah. It's like, what is their end game here? Do they just, they want... I don't, because like at the end of the day, like, what
do
they
want? It's not protecting animals. I don't think.
Yeah, it's not that. It's like, do y'all want humans to die? I think that's what they. I think they're like, man, just kill all humans and then leave animals as the only.
PETA will turn into like the eco-terrorist group from Cowboy Bebop. Remember that they protected the sea rats?
Yes.
You remember what I'm talking about?
Yes.
And they were led by like that deranged old woman who like would shoot up malls and shit.
That was a cute episode.
That was a great episode. I'm rewatching Cowboy Bebop with Anna. It's the first time she's seen it. That's the greatest show ever.
Yeah, PETA, again, I just don't know what the end game is. Sometimes they confuse me a lot, but
it's confusing.
There you go, furry walking a redheaded girl.
All right, well, speaking of a furry walking a redheaded girl, you want to gamble?
Oh, shit, I forgot we can gamble on this show.
Also, we forgot to set a topic for tonight's Let Us In Your House. Wednesday's stream, where we asked you to show us the contents of your refrigerator on the stream, went off very well, and we got many different entries. Do you or anyone else in the chat right now have a suggestion for what tonight's Let Us In Your House should be?
Show us that weird drawer in your house that has just random weird things in it.
Yes.
Like it's like got a small Crown Royal bag and then some change.
Chopsticks, old chopsticks.
Cigarette lighters and like a picture of like a Polaroid from your grandma or something. Just show us that weird dumb junk drawer you got in your house and what's in it.
Show us the junk drawer. Kengo says, nah, not the weird drawer.
Show us that weird drawer you got in
your house.
Bust
open that weird ass drawer for the Mystery School stream and go ahead and post it in the general chat of the Mystery School Discord by heading to this link or typing ?Discord in the chat. Oh, he's showing it. He's showing the hamussy. I like the nails just haphazardly, loosely in the corner as well. You're trying to bonk.
Tried to hit him. Try to give him a good thwack.
Damn. Oh, we got some junk drawer submissions already. I think it's time to pick out the gamble as well. What do you think?
All right. Today's first gamble. This will be a three-article bet here. Three articles.
Oh, dude, people are already posting their junk drawers.
Yeah, post that weird shit, man. Three articles. Ads will not be included.
Sorry. Oh, your Cole says, Mom lets me take something out of the drawer every Friday.
Oh,
it's a treat.
Some paper clips and a bag of tea or something. Nice. Like, that was the usual.
Anyway, sorry, you were concocting the gamble when I cut you off.
Oh, yeah. Three articles, no ads. This will be article only. And we're looking for a. We're looking for someone who is. We're looking for someone who is. Whose calf muscles are showing.
Oh, damn.
We're looking for calf muscles.
They're showing calf. Does it have to be a real person?
No, but it has to be in the article, no ads.
Does their flesh need to be exposed?
Yeah, there has they have to be exposed calves. Exposed calf
okay.
muscles.
Okay, all right. Fair enough.
Yeah.
Spig Fuck says, nah, this one is L. But then Oyer Cole says, easy.
Yeah, so it's a 50-50 bet, man. Anything could happen here.
Anything could happen.
I wouldn't gamble against calf muscles, but I wouldn't gamble for calf muscles either.
Yeah, I'm
either,
not sure, man. I don't know. I'm not sure exactly here. All right. Who's he going to put a bulls upset about the bet? But it's too late. It's already up. Cast
it's
your
up
votes.
There.
You can't resist. Throw all of those points in. Stimulate the Mystery School channel point economy, please. We'd appreciate it a lot. Just throw it in there with reckless abandon, please.
Yeah. Hip Hop Mon, they do not have to be muscular calves. They just need to be... Some regular old
calves. Some good old fashioned calves, man. You know? All right.
Calf muscle.
Muscle McAllister. Muscular baby cow, says Alex Coy.
Yeah.
Oh, we talked about that guy in the stream one time.
Well, there it is. We got a gamble up and rolling right now. It's time to let us in your house.
Oh, dude.
So
we got so many submissions.
Open up.
This is crazy. All right. Let's check out what's going on inside of people's houses. Ripples, believe it or not, with a pretty clean junk drawer.
Oh,
got some
wow.
light bulbs, tape, a battery, a glue top, and some scissors and keys.
You must have just moved there because nice. Junk drawers are, they take years to fill.
Khufu with a real junk drawer. We got multiple tapes.
Authentic.
Screwdriver, rusty hammer, menus for old pizza places, small nails.
Is that like hair, a bottle of like hairspray, that blue thing?
This is something with a cap on it, yes.
Oh, God.
Box cutter, presumably, and strange bags. This is what we're talking about, Cooper.
That's the junk drawer.
Kezzy yeah. Chase with a scale, a bowl, ashtray.
This is a weed selling drawer, not a junk drawer, bro.
There's also a sealed container of some sort here, a vape pen cartridge. Two boxes of new ports.
Two boxes, double ports.
And a hose of some sort that runs around.
All right, Cassie yes. with the drug drawer right there.
Cassie, thank you for that. Hip Hop Mon says, I can't open it, but I think it's pretty weird. Oh, there is some ancient forbidden treasure in there, man.
You might not want to open that, honestly.
Yeah, you might want to just leave that closed.
Just leave that.
Cheesecake Chimmy. Oh, with another. Oh, there's a Dragon Ball Z wallet. Some super glue. Batteries. Loose batteries. Some lace.
Is that a stud finder? The yellow thing? That's how you find the studs on the wall?
Yeah, nice.
Okay.
All right. Some pencils as well. Okay.
Chargers.
This may be a condom.
Might be. What did that junk drawer smell like? Can you give us a description of what that smells like in
Cedar
there?
Cedar and plaster is my guess. Oswaldo Crunch with a paste of some sort? IDs?
Goop?
These appear to be school IDs.
It's like concert tickets at the top
a
there.
A photo. These do look like tickets.
What is this? Plans of some sort?
Oh, very nice.
What's that camo thing? Is that a scale?
That's pretty nice. I don't know. TSX says, I'd just be putting in whatever.
The fucking microphone, first and foremost.
Is this rice? Is this an old cup of rice?
Bro, you gotta throw that out, man. It's gonna attract termites.
Garlic and herb dip. Some cables here. Or some red and blue pens.
Yarn?
Nice.
Pins. Look like a bill. Oh,
is that
yeah,
rice,
man,
bro? Is that OETV? Salsa Verde. With a jewel, chapstick, pen, Dutch Masters, screwdriver.
Name four things in this picture.
Heart-shaped sunglasses. I think this is some sort of weed bag, and I'm not sure exactly what that is.
Looks like, is that a humidifier or something? I don't know.
I can't really tell. That's actually hemorrhoid cream. Oh, nice.
I gotta have that. Okay, keep cool. that on deck.
And last one, we'll look at Guccifer's here. Oh, matches. There's always matches in my junk drawers, too.
Yeah. Look at the iPhone cable right there.
What is this? Fro sticks?
Fro stick?
It's weed of some sort. Some
okay,
dice.
Drugs.
Three die. Nice.
Damn, you do got the three die in there.
Nice.
And a little bit of weed paraphernalia.
All right.
Well, successful.
Thank you for letting us in your house, everyone. We'll throw back to this later for the next gamble. But for now, the gambles are in. Let's keep it moving. Let's see what else we got in the news tonight.
Let's go.
Also, oh, shit, we got a lot of articles left. And 49 minutes left on Lock, Sudden Death, which we are 9 subscribers away from.
Pretty close.
The odds are looking good of us making a full song live in under 30 minutes tonight. We got until 11 p.m. Central to hit that, a.k.a. 49 minutes from this moment in time right now. Meg Thee Stallion said I should buy Bitcoin, says Steady Fresh in the chat.
Good. You listen to Meg Thee Stallion.
Megan knows best for all of us. Surely she's giving us financial advice.
She said, hotties, buy Bitcoin now.
Now.
The bottom is in. Buy the Bitcoin.
Damn. Imagine Megan Thee Stallion just rebrands to like a technical analysis account on Twitter. Megan Thee Stallion.
Losing
like,
everybody millions of dollars.
As you can see, the Bitcoin is below the 30-day moving average and the bottom is in. It's time to buy.
That'd be tight.
I wouldn't be mad at that. I'll take some advice.
All right. Let's keep it going here. We got a quick one up next. Maybe we'll see some caps. Screening of The Batman interrupted after a person releases real bat into theater.
Ooh, I love that. That's a real plot twist right there.
How do you go see The Batman and get scared as a man when the real bat gets released?
Right. Are you the man or the bat? You got to figure that out.
The Nash Attack with 5 gifted subs.
Thank you, Nash
Thank
Attack.
Thank you very
Let's
much.
Go.
We appreciate that. That's how we got into this whole mess, says Gingerly Newman.
That's crazy. It's damn near 40 grown men in one theater all scrambling and hiding under chairs because one little bat is in the Batman movie.
For
like,
real.
Didn't you came here for this, right?
Yo, like Nasszilla with an organic non-GMO sub as well, a tier one. Thank you very much for that.
Thank you, Nasszilla.
And her swag in the chat says, Thank you for that. All right. It's just a prank. Moviegoer released a live bat at a recent showing of The Batman in Austin, forcing theater employees to interrupt the movie as animal control officers tried to remove the flying mammal from the premises. The incident occurred Friday at the Movie House and Eatery by Cinepolis in northwestern Austin. Annalise Hollyoake, the director of marketing communications for Cinepolis, confirmed in a statement Wednesday. Unfortunately. What do you mean, unfortunately? It's a thematic prank!
Right, that was sick. That was a tight one.
Fortunately, a guest tried to pull a prank at one of our locations. Local animal control was immediately contacted, and they oversaw the situation to ensure guest, associate, and animal safety.
I just want to talk to the dude that did this and just be like, so how'd you come up with this, bro? He'd be like,
man, me and my boy was just at home. And I was like, yo, what if we should take a bat to the Batman movie and let it out during the movie?
Where'd they get the bat? This poor bat, man. It was just used. It was an accomplice forcefully in this crime here.
I bet that bat was like in his pocket the whole way to the movie theater, just scratching and screaming like, God, Jesus Christ, help me.
Better prank if he waited for an opportune moment too, like when the Batman first appears on the screen and you just go with the bat out.
I love bats though, man. I remember at my family reunion as a kid, a bat got into the hotel lobby and was flying around and everybody was fucking losing it, man. People were jumping on the ground. Old ladies were like, stop dropping and rolling. It was craziness, man.
Yo, thankfully they didn't have to worry about this here. The bat flew out of an emergency exit door and was no longer in the building. Hollyoake said all moviegoers were offered full refunds, but the majority opted to stay and finish the film.
You know what? I'll finish the movie if there's no more bats.
Some people were like, you know what? This rogue bat ruined my experience of the Batman, and I have opted to not finish my movie-going experience here.
That would have got me in the mood even more, though. Like, I wish when I went to see the Batman, somebody would have released a live bat. I would have been like, damn, this shit is hype.
Dude, it's like 4D. Like, when you're in, you know, at, like, Disneyland or whatever, when they have the shit that's, like, the seats move around and it spritzes you with gusts of air and shit, you know?
Except this one bites you and gives you a little rabies and a little rash on your arm.
A little transmissible disease. You know?
A little COVID, but it's still a fun night out, you know?
It's cool. Yo, chat, in case you don't know what to do if a bat comes into an enclosed space, fun fact, my dad taught me this. You just shut the fuck up. Like, seriously, don't make any noise. If you got, like, a TV or music playing loudly, just turn it off. Because the reason the bats start freaking out is because everyone's screaming and it fucks up their echolocation. They're like, I can't see! I can't hear! And then they don't know where they're going and they freak out more. So, if a bat shows up, remember the simple two-step rule when a bat comes in. Step one, shut the fuck up.
step two, just like open a window or a door or something. It'll leave. It'll use its little echolocation to find out where it's going, you know?
It'll leave.
It'll leave on its own. It doesn't want to be there, man. Especially when you're getting all loud and agitated and screaming at it and it can't see well anymore.
Damn, that was probably so hype in that movie theater, though, man. It was dark in there, too, I bet. And everybody was just screaming bloody murder. And kids probably were like, ah, dad, that's a bad idea.
Yeah.
That had to be a good night out.
Yeah, man. That would have been pretty tight. Where am I? Says Alex in the chat.
Where am I?
Do you say that ads count or don't
they
count?
They do not. They do not.
Okay, so we only got this one image in the article here. I don't think that there's any calves. Well, actually, hold on. Oh, no, these people are clothed.
They're panted calves.
They're panted, for sure.
We're all right. For naked calves.
Well, somehow we unfortunately have a follow-up article to this next one that is thematically similar. Think forcing a stray animal into a private business and then doing something uncouth with it. We have two of those articles tonight on the stream. Following up immediately, a man accused of animal cruelty. A man accused of animal cruelty after squeezing pet rat inside fast food restaurant.
He grabbed his own rat and was like, you know what?
Oh. Why'd he squeeze him, man? He didn't need that.
I mean, rats are pretty squeezable, man. I thought you could squeeze your rat. But, damn. I mean, I guess you're not supposed to grip it like
that.
Dude,
PETA would hate the stream today. We got dogs getting called gay, bats getting released in the movie theater, and a guy gripping the hell out of his rat in a fast food restaurant.
Kango said he was gripping that bitch.
Oh, man.
I don't know what he gripped it so hard for, but... rats are very squeezable.
Also,
but
what's with this banner ad too promoting the Trill shit sale going on?
Gee, I thought he was definitely about to sell an eighth on this ad. Like,
got those $40 eighths all weekend long.
Dude, this
sale.
Is the rat squeezing demographic is about to click over to the Trill shit page and buy
Trill
some
shit sale.
Oh man! All right. Well, anyway, city police charged where? Where is this? This is from trappolitics.com. Who posted this?
Where y'all find that website from? I need to know.
The loyal reader of trappolitics.com getting all of their news updates from.
And that shit is a monthly subscription, so somebody subscribe to trappolitics.com.
Damn, like, I guess this is an article that relates to politics of the trap, I suppose.
They selling Trill shit. So.
Yeah, the hotspot for misinformation, says Deep Tech. All right, let's get into the article here. City police charged a man with animal cruelty involving a pet rat during a struggle with officers inside of a fast food restaurant. The cops were involved. Oh, man.
There was an officer-involved squeezing going on?
There was. Sebastian Thomas Dumarier, 38, address listed as homeless, collapsed inside McDonald's on East Northampton Street just after 3. This is a chaotic article, man. All right, sorry. Police and court records say Dumarier showed signs he was actively overdosing. Purple skin color and shallow breathing. As officers were evaluating him, a white rat was crawling on his chest when Dumarier was advised of an active warrant or advised of an arrest warrant. He initiated a struggle and violently squeezed his pet rat.
Yo, this... Ah, oh, man, this is the funniest thing I could have seen today, honestly, dude.
What the fuck is going on in this article, man?
Okay, let me break it down for you what's happening here. Oh. There was an older gentleman, 38 years old to be exact, inside of a fast food restaurant, presumably homeless, was clearly overdosing at the moment in the restaurant. Right. When officers began to approach the gentleman about his overdose, they also figured out that he had an outstanding warrant while he was having his overdose. They were like, oh, dude, you good? You having a heart attack, but
you also got 6 warrants here for
that. And then he had the rat, and he was like, ah!
I think just all the stress combined just caused him to just squeeze the shit out of his poor rat,
so,
man.
It says, when Dumarier was advised of an arrest warrant, he initiated a struggle and violently squeezed his pet rat, court records say, parentheses, Lord have mercy.
Who said Lord have mercy?
That was an editor's note put into the article here. Dumarier was told by officers he was killing his pet rat, and in return he released the animal and was handcuffed. And that's the end.
What the fuck did we just watch?
Where was this?
This was in a very cool place that I would like to visit sometime.
I gotta start reading trappolitics.com more, man. This article is incredible.
That was. There were so many twists and turns and just pure comedic gold in there, man.
We got Hugh Brawl at a Bronx seafood restaurant and Long John Silver's manager is charged with sexual harassment. Wow, the only news that matters here on trappolitics.com, we do, yes, a Hugh Brawl. Just kicks the player. Yes.
Hugh Brawl?
Damn. We encourage our viewers to post more articles from the site if you find them.
Yeah, we'll be rewarding you for posting Trap Politics news. Ray J. Because that was rare. I've never seen anything like that.
Ray J simply says, trill shit in the chat. Agreed. Wait, yeah, there are only 33 views on this entire article.
All of them us. They're all from Mystery School.
Oh,
sure.
Man. Who posted this? Hold on. I need to go find this in the stream news section.
Did one of y'all make that website, man? Because if you did, I'm very pleased with
Trap
you. You did a great
politics.
Job.
Oh, wait, I can't query this. Can someone look in the stream news section and see who posted that? Because we need to commend them for their journalistic integrity.
I'm still just buzzing off of just all these animals doing weird shit.
It was Koganon.
Koganon posted that.
Koganon, thank you for posting this.
Thank you, man. That was fire.
That was an excellent article, man. We're really pleased that we got to talk about that.
Damn, went from overdose to getting arrested to squeezing his rat all in one fell swoop.
There is like a very obvious rat calf in this image here. But I don't think that counts.
I said humans. Yeah it's got to be human.
Yeah, for real. SSG Zombie in the chat. What's up, man? Good to see you.
Rat paws.
Rats don't have calves. Yeah, we're not going to call it for the rat calf here.
Yeah.
Oh,
well,
Jesus Christ.
What a news day. It's Friday. I guess the world is just letting it all rip.
Yep, it's letting it all rip. And unfortunately, the rippage does not stop there. This next portion is kind of a segment. I don't really know. We'll just check back in after this next couple articles here. All right, check this out.
All right.
Woman sues over delivery of chocolate penis with no redeeming qualities. Well, what? I guess I don't know the checklist that you go down when you get delivered a chocolate penis. Like, this is not up to standard.
She probably was looking for that big-ass vein that's on the Snickers and ended up not finding it and was very disappointed.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Had no vein, says most of our chat.
Yeah, I'm feeling like it was no vein on that Snickers.
It had no vein like the Snickers. Flavor, size, amount of nuts, says Owie TV. Look at this stock photo here, like,
is this my dick I ordered? Oh, shit.
A woman is suing a novelty gift company for sending a life-size dick-shaped chocolate to her door, citing fear, nervousness, anxiety, worry, and indignity at receiving the phallic confection on her doorstep.
Wow.
Wow, so she just saw the gigantic chocolate penis and it was just too much?
There were no redeeming qualities to it. It's probably just like a plain old, just veinless, headless dick.
If it was nicer, then maybe it would have been fine. As reported by Courthouse News, the complaint filed by Linda Parks in Ventura County, California on Tuesday details the emotional distress Parks received when she got an unexpected chocolate dick delivery from the company Dick at Your Door, owned by Rain Parade LLC. Dick at Your Door sells a range of prank items beyond the Choco Dongs. They also offer chocolate buttholes with the message Live Fast, Eat Ass printed on a box, bag of dicks, gummies, and glitter bombs. The complaint claims that... Oh, can I show this? I don't know if I can. The complaint claims the 5-inch chocolate phallus has...
It looks a little realistic. I don't know, man.
No redeeming social qualities whatsoever. She's suing for damages, including psychological counseling, lost wages, and the cost of the suit.
This lady took off work after the dick wasn't pleasing her? Oh, man. She lost real hourly wages.
If only we could see what it looks like here on the stream. Hold on. I'm going to pan away here so we can scroll by this.
Pan away from it.
Oh, I mean, there are veins. It is incredibly realistic. There's even, like, testicle, like, skin wrinkles on it, too. And, like what I believe it's the frenulum is wrinkled as well.
That's your the little foreskin turtleneck fold over thing.
Yes.
Yeah. Welp. Disappointing dick at her door. They dropping dick off is something I read in the chat as well. They dropping dick off
the coop. Not a wrinkled frenula. No. Frenulum. Frenulum. Didn't everyone pay attention in biology class?
It looks like a Snickers.
It does kind of look like a Snickers.
It doesn't taste like one. I don't think you better not pop that in your mouth.
It also says, this isn't the first time Dick at Your Door has been sued by someone on the receiving end of their candies. In 2016, a human resources director at a Dallas-based technology company sued Dick at Your Door for the name, telephone number, and address of the person who anonymously sent her a bag of dicks. Damn.
Wow.
Well, they probably didn't have to disclose that. Dick at your door didn't do anything bad. I said didn't do anything bad because I was reading Eat a Bag of Dicks.
Yeah, there's definitely bags of dicks to go around with Dick at Your Door services. Welp, sorry to that lady. And did she have to go through that to realize that she's not a fan of chocolate dicks anymore?
Yeah. Well, she took off work. She lost money. Her life got all fucked up after she opened that box and a hyper-realistic chocolate penis was in there staring her back in the eye.
I mean, hey, don't bite off more than you can chew.
Megan Maxine says, a lot of dicks tonight. Are there a lot of dicks tonight?
There was this one, and then the Snickers dick vein.
I think those were the only penises we've mentioned directly or otherwise tonight. Mike Tyson bit in the ear. There was a pickles with Snickers in them.
Somebody squeezed a rat like a dick could be squeezed,
I guess. Poor rat, man. He didn't know what the hell's going on.
Damn, and then he just got released into the wild because his owner went to jail. Yeah. Like, he's a fucking rat, man.
Outstanding warrants and shit. All right, okay. Usually we don't do disclaimers on the stream. This next article, it's not spiders. There's no triggering imagery. I'm gonna warn you. Like, we talk about some raunchy shit here on the show. This next one may actually make some of you feel bad. I don't know if I can fully give it away. It's not a penis. It's actually a female genitalia article here. It involves something stuck or lodged in and or around. If that's not your cup of tea, I would seriously suggest to look away from the stream for like the next 2 minutes or so.
There's no blood, is there?
There's no blood. There's no. Well, I'm not gonna show that, but there's.
Oh, okay. All right. Well,
it's a little graphic. Okay, and this might make some of you squeamish. So. Just look at the chat and you'll see when it's over. There's not going to be any graphic images, but if you're squeamish about this sort of thing, here we go. Woman's UTI was actually glass tumbler lodged in bladder for 4 years.
That's painful. Yeah, I get it. I get why you gave a disclaimer.
Megan Maxine said, I'm staying.
I'm staying here to see it. Megan, well, there it is. This is it.
A tumbler.
What is a tumbler?
There's a photo of it.
Like a glass? Like a cup? It's a fucking cup!
Yeah. How'd it get in there?
What?
For 4 years, too? Wouldn't you experience some sort of discomfort?
A glass cup?
Yeah.
Those ain't little. That's not a shot glass, either. Like, that's a full-sized cup.
Yeah.
How did it get in there? I need to know now.
Let's check it out here. Ooh, there could have been some caps exposed here, but definitely not. A woman whose doctor thought had a UTI actually had a glass tumbler stuck inside her bladder for 4 years. The 45-year-old had come to the hospital complaining of typical lower UTI infection symptoms, such as leaking. But doctors were stunned when scans revealed there was a glass inside her bladder. It was encased. Oh, okay, this is actually pretty bad.
Encased? I'm done, man. I don't want any more pain.
It was encased in a bladder stone. I didn't even know that was a thing. Do I have to worry about that?
Oh, wait. So that like Jurassic Park-ass fossil thing was inside of her? I thought they just like placed that there for like comparison or something, dude.
Yes.
Damn. So she really had a fucking stone in there?
Yeah, this is pretty bad.
This is terrible, man. This person is scaring me.
The woman from Tunisia revealed she had used the drinking glass as a sex toy for a number of years before. Evidently, she had Okay, I think this actually might be too graphic to read the rest of, man. Hold on, let me skim this.
Can I see that fossil again?
Now, I don't know if it's TOS. I thought that was just something they were holding it in.
Yeah, I thought that was just like a cup holster, but that's a fossil that was in her bladder, and it... If the cup is this big, then that stone had to be this big in her. She didn't feel that?
Okay.
What the fucking hell, man?
The rest of this article is so unhinged. I'm going to post this in the meme section of the Mystery School Discord, the censored text, if you want to read this. It's too hot for the stream, actually. So everyone just take a look at the quotes, the quote that I'm about to drop in the meme section of the Discord, which is 18 and up. So type question mark Discord in the chat.
no kink shaming here, man, but how'd you forget that you shoved that glass up there, man? Like, that's not something that's easy to forget. Like, that's a whole fucking glass.
Yeah. And you think, like, you would have your fun with it, and then you'd be like, oh, wait, where's my glass?
Yeah, or like, I should get that out of there. Is that still in there? Let me. Oh, there's where it is. But how do you forget about that for so long to the point where it becomes encased in a fossilized stone?
Sometimes people. So this quote, the part that I can read about urethral sounding. Anyone see that image of the Elden Ring sounding meme on Reddit? That shit was really funny. Anyway.
Maidenless.
The woman. Yeah, so urethral sounding. Doctors have reported people deliberately place things up there. Never mind. Let's forget that we talked about this article.
Yeah, it's fine. I hate it. No kink shaming here, dude. Stick everything that you can stick up there, but just remember to get it back out if you can. Yeah, you know, just take it back
out. Let this be a public health notice. Oh my god, there's some racy shit in this article.
Go back to the rat squeezing article. Yeah, I want to go back to where the dude let a bat out in a movie theater. Man.
Yeah, who posted this? We should start a new segment where we narc on the people that in the Discord that posted the most heinous articles of the day
and punish them too. Yeah, we should definitely do that. We will reward the good articles and then let's punish the articles that make us feel sick.
Definitely.
So whoever got this one, step up and get your punishment, man. Dude, like, we just want to talk.
Dangerous article we opened here. There's an ad on the bottom that says high-end Hornley Lottie Moss goes topless in OnlyFans video after rehab.
Dansky Heel said, "Mystery school dark as hell tonight."
Yeah, we got rat squeezing. We got urethral sounding, man.
We got bat letting out. Yeah. Bat freeing.
Oh, actually, I have the perfect follow-up to this that I didn't open on the stream before.
There's no follow-up to this. You can't follow this up unless you got a Jurassic Park article with a fossilized doo-doo or something.
They're actually... Okay, so this was anecdotal recently or earlier today. What the hell was this guy's name? Zach. There's this guy who reports on Twitch News. Zach Boosie. Here we go. This guy... He's a guy who has an entire career about... Oh, shit. Megan Maxine with the 5 gifted subs.
Thank you, Megan.
Sudden death has been unlocked.
Oh, damn. Just like that. Sudden death is here.
Megan.
All right.
Thank you so much for your generosity on the stream. We really appreciate that. Everyone who contributed tonight's sudden death, we appreciate that very much.
Thank you. It must have been the fossilized cup article that did it.
So, speaking of our run-ins with being TOS, according to him, he's got like a bunch of Twitch leaks early. This is unconfirmed. Twitch is teasing a new mature content policy that may enable a lot of after dark content, albeit with new restrictions/enforcement on the mature flag. We would probably have to stream with this. Then we could have shown the chocolate dick and stuff on the stream.
Yeah.
I feel like this would be much better suited to the stream. I think the stream would actually gain quality if we could show TOS things, like, openly, right?
Right. I feel like that. Because we're not trying to, like... specifically just show you like fucking like
porn or something.
But sometimes in these articles there are things that are very relevant to the article, but they are TOS under Twitch's standards.
Right,
so,
for real.
Yeah, that might help us out a lot.
Hippie Rhetoric, thank you for that gifted sub. So I am actually kind of hopeful that this comes through. That was something I was thinking about the other night for no particular reason, was like the economics of all these streaming services and how Twitch is so stringent about at times what's allowed on the platform. I feel like they might, like, why doesn't, well, I know why they don't, but I feel like Twitch could just be like, yeah, there's Twitch, and then there's Twitch mature version, and then they just capture a wider range of content, you know, content, right? Like, I feel like that would be a wise move, but I'm sure they have shareholders and shit that wouldn't like that, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, but siphoning it into its own little realm, I think, would be all right. Yeah. I think that would be the way to do it, because then shareholders don't even have to concern themselves with that. They're like, oh, that's all in that little small corner of Twitch. So
for real.
I don't got to worry about that.
Yeah, so anyway, we'll talk about more extreme shit in the future, because Twitch, you know, lets us talk about mature filter stuff. About a dollar with the tier 2 resub for 5 months. Thank you very much for that.
Thank you, Bada-Dala. Appreciate that.
SSG Zombie continuing the gift sub they got from Crash Fleet. SSG Zombie, good to see you, man. Welcome back. Thank you very
beautiful,
much.
Beautiful, beautiful stuff there.
Mystery School After Dark, urethral sound in Fridays. This big fucks.
Man, I'm just still grossed out by that fossil that cup was inside of. Never mind. All right, I'm not going to
I got a nice palate cleanser for you, dude. I got something that'll take your mind off of all of
Please,
it.
please, because I'm hurting inside.
I got something for you here. Consider the Plano, Texas Town Council meeting.
Oh, yes.
Daddy, I'm the proof. When I'm in a booth, spitting on the mic. Anti-vax. Putin hates all of
them.
Did
he say N-word and they bleeped him?
No, he's just, his mic is clipping.
Oh, I was like, damn, they edited him.
Putin's anti-vax and he hates blacks was that bar, if you missed that.
Big bar, all right.
He's a bad racist. Put him in the ground, white or brown. And I'm
wait.
Hold on, I got the NAACP on the line and they just said.
Hold on, run. I got to run this back.
Run that back.
I'm the proof when I'm in a booth, spitting on the mic. Anti-vax. Putin hates all of them blacks. Putin is a bad racist. Put him in the ground, white or brown. And I'm in Plano Town. And you know you just got found. I'm a pimp on a blimp. Eating less of steak and shrimp. No, you can't stop my shine. I'm number 99. And you know I grind and shine.
Okay.
Teaching class. Oh. This is your whole class. Zelensky is a VIP. Ukraine and I go insane. Put a bullet in Putin's brain.
Damn, he's
you
going crazy.
This is the plan. I'm a Zelensky stan.
Oh.
I love you, Vladimir Zelensky. You are so smart. What's the smell? Did somebody fart?
Damn.
No way. What can you say? Fascinate me straight or gay.
You.
Wait.
What did he say? Wait. Huh.
Did he say?
What did he say?
Hold up.
Run it back for me one time, man. It's a lot to unpack here.
Did somebody fart? No way. What can you say? Fascinate me straight or gay.
Damn, he said, fascinate me straight or gay.
I'm thinking W for the assassinate Putin pro-vaccination, pro-Zelensky rap.
Honestly, not too far off of the average Freestyle Friday right there, man. I think he got talent and potential, to be real.
Holy
He could definitely hold his own on this show.
Dude, he was my favorite was when he turned his head away from the mic and started rapping at the two people in the background, and you could really hear the beat come through because it wasn't clipping anymore.
He did a little dance and shit. Yeah. Yeah, honestly, I'm a little intimidated, dude. Like, I think he honestly is a equally as powerful freestyler as myself,
yeah.
Man.
If he was freestyling just now,
yeah, I'm a little intimidated. I might have to diss him just out of proactivity. Just be proactive and diss him before he diss me.
Come on the stream, dude. Come on the stream.
Yeah. Anybody, can you guys reach out to this guy, see if he'll give us a video call on the stream? We'd love to just talk about what happened.
Remix that shit? I would love to, man. He was 1,000% freestyling. Spooky Rockets, thank you for the 13-month resub. Is this an NFT, ask her swag?
I'm a little jealous, honestly. Like, can I diss this man? Because he actually came with some bars real quick, live in front of Parliament.
He hit some rhyme schemes on that, I'm not going to lie. The bars were extraordinarily questionable and maybe against international law.
Some were bordering on racist too, but I don't think that was his intention. I think you know sometimes in the freestyle
he just got caught up in the moment. You know?
Just say shit to rhyme. SSG Zombie, thank you for that.
Thank you, man.
Gift
welcome
right
back, bro. We appreciate that. He turned up, says BKWGOC.
He definitely blicked up real quick for the whole crowd. And that pretty much is American politics in a nutshell right there. You got old people watching this guy do that in a fucking Parliament courthouse somewhere, and then we make a law.
Yeah,
that's government.
That dude, I would just watch the rest of that in awe, but I think we need to keep moving on the stream tonight, man.
We should try to
Jesus
as
Christ.
Best as we can.
That was incredible. Anti-vax, pro anti-Ukraine, racist, sudden death, says Moko Jojo.
Mm-hmm.
Damn,
no, he was pro-vax, right?
Yes,
he said vaccinate me straight or gay. I'm about to get vax today.
And he also at the beginning he said like something like fuck Putin, he's anti-vax, and you know he hates them blacks, I believe, was the line.
And he hates
he hates them black. So Vladimir Putin, man, I wasn't aware of your black hatred like that.
He's gonna have to respond in kind.
You definitely should figure out a response before I get on this myself, man.
Yeah, he's gonna have to. Dude, I think we're politics streamers now after seeing this. That was really incredible, honestly.
I got a stance that I'll stand on.
Adriana says he's making good points though, not gonna lie. He do be spitting, honestly. Yeah, put him in a Putin. The lyric was Putin is a bad racist. Put him in the, ground, white or brown.
White or brown.
Jesus Christ.
Like, yeah. All right. I don't. I'm teetering on racism here, but like not quite. I feel his heart.
He was trying
I don't feel
to be
his
an
heart
ally
as racist.
So bad that he accidentally almost became racist.
It happens like that sometimes. You know, when you're trying to be not horny so much that you end up getting horny regardless, man.
He did a different pro-vax rap. I seen it. Damn, this guy has a budding career. We got to get him on the
He seems like the perfect fit for this stream.
We got to get him on the stream. All right, well, there were no caps that were shown. Did we pay out that bet?
Let's pay that out. I knew in the bottom of my heart that that was a losing bet. I just had to do that to stimulate the economy, man. So,
yeah.
My bad to everybody that lost a lot of money on that one.
It was like a 50-50 split, man.
I knew the whole time that you guys weren't going to win that, man. So,
pimp on a blimp eating lobster steak and shrimp bars, says Sean, dude. His flow atrocious, says Laker fan. Hey, careful, dude. You're about to get barred up talking about him like that. He might come for you.
Who made that fucking beat, though? Like, damn.
Yeah. Those little, chimes, those, Soldier Boy bells going on. That was actually tight.
Yeah, that was a slapper.
All right. Well, on that note, we only have time for a couple more articles. There are a lot of bangers we actually have to save for Monday, I believe.
Twas a Friday where we saved articles.
I think we have just enough time to hit the rest of these articles. Chuck on that, says Big Bugs. Do you think we should gamble once more before we continue here? We've got three more articles, I believe.
Yeah, let's just do one last three-article gamble here.
All right.
This one, I promise, I don't know what's going to happen, but there is a 50-50 chance of you winning and losing. I know that for sure. Let's do a three-article gamble here. Ads are included this time, man. I feel bad about what I did to you guys on the last gamble, to be honest.
And if you haven't posted in the Discord, tonight's Let Us In Your House segment is brought to you by posting the random junk drawer that you have in your house. Just go ahead, open it up, snap a pic, and drop it in the general chat of the Mystery School Discord. We'll be evaluating it with our viewers live tonight.
Mm-hmm. Nice, nice. All right. Well, I think that for these next three articles, I'll switch it up a little bit. Will the article title, the title of the article, which is in text, will the title of the article begin with a vowel? For the next three articles, will the title of the article begin with a vowel?
Truly a 50-50 gamble. That's a good one, man.
Switch it up a little bit. Obviously, ads don't count because they have nothing to do with the title of the article. So it's pretty self-explanatory right there.
Well, Big Baby says, I was on the NPC making it blip blop for dude.
Yeah, you definitely squeaked that out for him, man. Good job.
Room Illiterate says, rat calf hive. Not letting go of the fact that that little tiny rat being gripped had its calves extended in the air. Splayed in the air.
Poor baby, man. Poor rat, I hate seeing small animals be squeezed.
We do not condone the treatment of any animal on the stream tonight. Or PETA, for that matter.
The police were like, yeah, you're under arrest. And dude was like, oh!
And they're like, stop squeezing the rat!
I don't want now you're under arrest for squeezing the rat! That should be a crime. Like,
get him, he's squeezing a rat. You're under arrest.
Damn. All right, the gamble is up right now. Let's check out the Discord and see what's going on in some of these drawers.
Yeah, I hope you guys found some cool stuff.
Tick to West with two oven mitts.
Bunch of bags. Ziploc bags.
What is this? Call your, I don't know. Some
phone sex hotline card.
Some wall hangers, a little suspicious red thing. Oh, chopsticks, dude. I'm surprised I haven't seen more chopsticks. My little shit drawer has so many chopsticks in it. Yeah. And plastic bags, too. A lot of plastic bags.
Y'all don't just throw all your receipts into one random drawer? Like, what's wrong with y'all?
Can we get a one in the chat if you have a plastic bag drawer that just busts with plastic bags the second you open it, and all the plastic bags are stuffed inside of other plastic bags in, like, a nested sequence as well?
Oh, God, man.
Yes, that's what I'd like to see. The Black Oddity with Energizer batteries, small animals showing their asses,
What the fuck is that, man?
It says, but this one, and then these creatures are showing their cracks.
Cool. I guess that's fire.
Nice. A little keyboard manual. Sonic the Hedgehog. Board. No, is this a Rick and... Yo, this is a Rick and Morty beanie.
That's almost Cookie Monster fitted energy, man.
I can tell from the colors and angle that this is a Rick and Morty beanie, man.
Yeah, I'm getting Cookie Monster fitted energy from that right there.
Tom Shishido says, Crown Royal bag shaking my head. Damn, you called him out.
Yeah. That's a classic junk drawer right there. The antithesis.
Oh, dude, and you got some. Okay, you got all the hallmarks of the junk drawer here. Batteries with just loose batteries of different kinds. A random remote from something that people probably forgot what it goes to.
Don't even have that
Crown
thing
Royal
anymore.
Bag and cables haphazardly woven together.
Yeah, that's a junk drawer right there, man. Nice. And they always just smell like a variety of things, you know. Steph's never stinky, though.
Steph Zero says IDK. Me either. Name one thing in this photo here.
What's red? Like, why is this happening to me?
It's a disorienting drawer.
Is that a blue vibrator? Like, what's that little teardrop looking thing? That looks like a vibrator.
I cannot name one thing that I'm looking at.
I see a yellow loop, and then I see a blue teardrop.
Oh, wait. This is a lighter, I think, and that might be a pen. I have no idea what else I'm looking at here.
Why are so many things red in this picture, man? What the fuck am I looking at?
Dude.
I'm getting upset, man. I'm getting offended from this.
I'm confused. Yeah, I don't. Are these candies? That's an Old Bay. Why is it so tiny?
Oh, that's a personal-sized Old Bay
that
you take on trips with? Yeah, we got to get out of here.
We
got to
get out of here. Oh, my God. Okay, let me just...
Everything was so red and so confusing.
This was a very successful Let Us In Your House today, everyone. We appreciate all the participation. There's some honorable mentions here that we might have to scroll through later in the stream. Thank you for posting these, everyone. I feel like the junk drawer shows a lot about our viewers' personalities, you know?
Yeah, I'll post my junk drawer after the stream. Yeah. I'll take a picture of it, let you guys see what I got.
All right, well, speaking of junk drawers, it's time for tonight's title article before we get into some fucking crime. Check it out. Slobbing out and giving up? Why are so many people going goblin mode? You know, I'm going to just go ahead and answer for him here. Brink of World War III, extremely high inflation, the Great Resignation...
Maidenless.
Elden Ring came out. Stagflation. NFTs. Sonic the Hedgehog 2 movie coming out soon with Idris Elba's Knuckles. There's a lot of reasons to go goblin mode in 2022.
Who's not already in goblin mode is what I want to know.
Yeah.
Like, I thought that was the norm at this point. Like, we just lived in our houses for 2.5 years straight with no jobs and no income and no reason to really like anything. So yeah. I think everybody's stuck in goblin mode permanently.
Real Gamer 261 says, they call me the slobbing goblin in the chat with no context.
Slobbling goblin.
Nice. Thank you. What is goblin mode? Asks Big Baby Sess. Goblin mode is whatever... Oh, here's actually an academic definition of it. The term embraces the comforts of depravity and a direct departure from the cottagecore influence of early pandemic days. It's essentially like, fuck it, I gave up. I don't wear pants anymore. My bed is covered in roaches, like roach clips. And
masturbate at least 4 times a day.
Yeah, you masturbate regularly. You eat fast food a lot. You know, you just kind of slobbing it out, going goblin mode. Okay, on a scale of 1 to 5... 1 being the least goblin mode, 5 being full-on fucking gremlins skittering around picking up trinkets off the ground. How goblin mode are you right now, Chad?
Skittering?
Oh, we got some 5s and a 4.9 from Real Gamer. 10.
I would say I vibe with the... I vibe with the goblin state of mind,
yes.
But just the physical filth of it. Mm-hmm. The physical filth of it, I don't get involved with. But state of mind, yeah, I'm a goblin for sure. I just can't be living in sticky stuff.
I would say on the goblin Richter scale here, I'm probably a cool 1.8, I would say. The stream honestly keeps me from going full goblin. I would like to goblin out. Yes. If it wasn't for the stream, I would just go, and then play Elden Ring for 49 hours straight.
I want to do that, though. I'm trying to do that. I'm trying to do that after the stream, man.
You people keep me from full-on gobbling.
Gobbling it up.
I'm a drooling goblin, says Hippie Rhetoric.
Yeah.
So anyway, there isn't much to explain here, man. It's just like we're all fucking burned out. Like, it's still the pandemic, kind of. World War III's here.
Oh, and then, like, I was just talking about this earlier. Like, they're so funny being the, like, cabal shadow leaders of the world. Like, they threw us from pandemic into World War III, yeah, and then sprinkled a little hyperinflation on top of it and charged us extra money for gas. So,
yeah, for real.
It's all happening at the same time, man. I don't know how they expect us to not go goblin mode, yeah, man. Like, you can't drive your car because you can't buy $100 worth of gas every 2 days. Like,
yeah, goblin mode is basically like state sanctioned at this point. The government is encouraging us to go goblin mode at this point.
Yeah, shout out my G's, man. All my geek goblins. All my G-joblins out there, man.
Laker fan says, Owen, stream Elden Ring already, bruv. Is that something that you all be interested in? I forget that I can stream games on Twitch. I thought we have to do the first interactive late night show on the net where the hosts are also the musical guests.
Yeah.
If people would like to see me stream Elden Ring, I would love to, dude. I am goblined out on Elden Ring. I'm like level 93 on my first playthrough or some
shit. I'm fucking like level 27, and I hate my... I love... It's fun, but like... These little bastards, and they hang out with this, fucking guy who's got a gold fucking like scepter or something, and he's sitting on these stairs. And every time I get near him, he wakes up he's like, and I'm like, dude, I wasn't even fucking talking to you. I was trying to fight the weak dudes down there at the bottom of the stairs.
Talking to you.
And then he's like, nope, well I'm here now. And then he grabbed me by the back of the neck, and I die in one hit every time. And that's just been it took me 3 hours. I tried to watch a YouTube guy tell me how to get OP with a samurai in 20 minutes. He was like, this is how you become OP in samurai in 20 minutes. I followed all his instructions up until that point. And then I was like, well, what do you do about the fucking weird statue monster that keep on hitting me? And he was like,
you just got to run around him, mate. You got to avoid him. You can't get hit by him.
All right, well. Yeah, you know, who said that? My dog's Jeff says, squeeze Tony like a rat.
He definitely come up to me and just,
All right, well, I'll stream some Elden Ring this weekend. How about it? My Twitch channel is just twitch.tv/OwenBones. You know, same handle elsewhere. I'll tag everyone in the Discord if you're interested in that.
It's a fun, angering game. I haven't got this angry at a game
once
in a while.
You kind of hit like a runner's high about like 10 hours in where you just crave the pain and then it all kind of clicks. That's been my experience with every like FromSoft game, like Sekiro, Dark Souls. Like the first 10 hours, you're like, why God? And then eventually you just ascend and it's like, ah, yes.
I'm at the point right now where it's like, I see a big, scary, mean guy that I know hurt me, and I just go up to him, like, do what you want, dude. Like,
have
fuck it, I don't care.
Me.
Like, let me see what you can do. Like,
right, for real.
Swing on me, bitch. Like, I don't got nothing to lose. I got $0. All my runes are scattered across the land after multiple deaths. Like, it doesn't even matter.
Yo, Bob Eggs, welcome back for Tier 3. 35 months, Bob Eggs says, still ain't graduated. Don't worry, the diploma's in the mail somewhere, dude. It'll show up one of these days.
Yeah, it's cool, man.
Anyway... Now that we've all gone goblin mode and established that I should goblin out on my personal Twitch channel playing Elden Ring, we got time for two final articles here on the stream before we get into sudden death. And actually, computer?
What's good?
Take us to the crime dimension.
Okay. Oh, prepare yourself, little bitch.
Okay. All right. Well.
It smells different here, but it's the crime dimension nonetheless. It
smells different here.
Let's get ready for today's best and worst crimes, all presented to you by our sponsor, Gillette Razors.
Yeah.
Presents today's Method Watch.
Gillette Razor, we created the segment in partnership with them, which is nicking the area directly to the right of your balls and to the left of your inner thigh when trying to shave. Thank you to our sponsors.
Specific but accurate, man. Thank you. Oh, it hurts.
Gillette Razors, I spit on my screen. I just cleaned it all off, so it's fine. Anyway, try this one on for size. Alleged stoner stopped after wild car chase, whips out license from Legoland.
Hey, anybody can relate to this in the chat? Let me know, man. You ever been so fucked up that the cops pull you over after a wild chase and you whip out your old Lego license?
And look, they invalidated his Lego license. He got it punched at Legoland, even.
They're like, you're fucking out of here. License suspended, man.
Damn. Oh, City Lifestyle 01, welcome back for 5 months. Appreciate that very much.
Thank you, City Lifestyle.
I like that they say alleged stoner, too. He was just like, oh, sorry, dude.
No, this is a confirmed stoner right here, man.
Cassie Chase says, I lost 100% of the gambles tonight. I have 70 points. How am I supposed to pay rent? Surely one of our chatters will loan you channel points at a high interest rate.
Dude, Ray J got millions of points. Dude, just find him on his way to his car after the stream and just, you know, have a small combo with a knife.
A UK driver who was arrested for reckless driving had officers in stitches after producing a license from Legoland. Yo, Dumb Hob, thank you for the gifted sub, man. The driver was pursued by Bexley to Isle of Sheppey and arrested for a multitude of offenses last week. According to a tweet by the Kent Police, which apprehended the 21-year-old motorist in February following an epic chase. The fiasco began after officers attempted to pull over an Audi A7 they had observed maneuvering recklessly all over the road. However, the driver refused, resulting in a 35-mile chase that took them from southeast London to Kent. They were even forced to call in a police helicopter. Eventually, the pursuing officers caught up with the knucklehead after he ran out of gas, whereupon they found a large stash of marijuana in his car.
Wow, America's so different. They would have killed this guy in America. They would have shot him 17 times.
They would have just thrown those spikes on the road, let the car roll over five times, and then mag dumped into the shit upside down.
While the car's smoking upside down, they would have just let it rock in his shit,
but
man.
But they did call him a knucklehead.
Ah, good old London knucklehead headry there.
Damn, and he was like, maybe this is something like about his identity, you know, if he was moving weight. Well, this doesn't look like weight. It just looks like a...
just a smoker's dozen right there.
A zip in the back. He's like, oh, I gotta protect my identity. Legoland license.
Here you go, officer. It's me, Legoland license.
When officers asked his documentation, he brandished a fake license he received from Legoland as a kid in 2003.
Oh, so he wasn't even legally able to drive on this license. No. So, all right.
There's his Lego number, though.
I was a cop, I would have looked at it and be like, let me run the fucking numbers on this, man. Went through and did some research on it. I would have came back and be like, yeah, looks like you're all clear. You're in the clear here, man. Make sure you get out of here and don't let me see you again tonight.
And he had some real hairy looking weed, too.
That don't look bad. Damn, especially for London.
I don't know, man. I see some leaves and just like trimmings on it.
I don't look half bad for London weed.
Oh, well,
man.
Actually, this is more weed than I thought. This is the car, entire car door for reference. It's pretty big.
Oh, he got like 2 pounds in there. At least.
Rich Homie Doge says, looks frail. The weed does look a bit frail. He had that moss, as Big Baby says. He's reportedly been released on bail. So he's fine. He's going to go drive recklessly again with a Legoland license.
Well, next time, buddy, just leave the Legos at home, man.
Yeah.
Don't bring those on the road.
Yeah, or at least pass the Legoland driving test. They even invalidated that shit. All right. Watching a fight outside my apartment right now, says Laker fan.
Who's winning?
Yeah, who's winning? He was smoking lichen. This is General So. All right. Well, we got one final article for the stream tonight. And this is one that I think is going to win over the hearts and minds of most of our viewers here. We haven't done an article like this before, actually. So excited to see how you feel about this. There's a picture that refuses to load for some reason. It would have given some added context. But for now. Elderly woman dubbed the hugging bandit pickpocketed victims after pretending to know them, police said.
Definitely W method right there. That's a W. Old ass lady just, hey, come here, Sonny. Good to see you again. I haven't seen you in so long.
I feel
give
like being an old lady is the perfect disguise? Type of person to be to do crime.
100%, man. Nobody is giving a fuck about you, man. Like, you can literally hurt someone and people will be like, ah, oh, she's just an old lady,
sorry,
man. She just
my frail bones accidentally fired that round off. It's okay, ma'am.
She just ran over 6 kids in the fucking marathon, man. But, you know, I couldn't see that they were in front of me in the car.
Adriana says, y'all hugging old ladies you don't know? No, that's the point, is that, like, if an old lady comes up to you and tries to give you a hug, you're not going to be like, get off me. You'll probably be like, oh, uh-oh.
Back up before I bust your ass, old lady.
Oh, shit. Oh, no. Granny, stop the scamming. Stop the thieving. Anyway, old people smell funny sometimes, too, says Mercenary Gary.
It's not funny. They smell unique and different is what we call it in my household.
I'm definitely going to tell her to back the fuck up, says Charlie Torque. I mean, I'd be like confused. I'd be like, oh, ma'am, please get off of me. But you're not going to be like, get off me, you crazy old lady.
Crazy whore. Let me go, Jezebel.
But like, if a grown ass man comes up to you and tries to hug you, you will say that to them, you know?
Nah, old lady, I know myself, man, yeah. And I think very deeply about things. So immediately my brain will process like, she probably lost her grandson. She's probably really lonely. Right. She probably needs this hug really bad. Let me hug this old lady.
Or
she,
keep it moving. She's having a moment.
Yeah, or she might be having a senior moment right now. Let me hug her and just keep it moving, man.
But if you're just like, hey, robbed me. Get out of here.
Shove her to the ground and call it, yo, this bitch just tried to, yeah, I need two squad cars over here.
No one's doing that. It's the perfect disguise. An elderly Florida woman is accused of pickpocketing strangers by pretending she knew them while giving them a hug, swiping their credit cards and wallets. Please. Yeah, she's just like, oh, it's you from the bingo lounge. Come give Mima a hug. And what are you going to be like? No, lady, get out of here. Like, you'll probably
I remember your first soccer game. Come here and just give old granny a hug.
It's the perfect disguise. Kathy Stevens, nicknamed the Hugging Bandit by police, is being held in the Pinellas County Jail on more than a dozen charges. Stevens, 65, allegedly targeted older men and would approach them outside of stores. Oh, so she was not even using, like, senile charm. She was like, it's just me, sexy old granny.
Oh, she was using that cougar pussy is what she was doing. Mm-hmm. She was using that old panther to lure in some horny old men. It was like, I got a hug for you. If you need one, Eustace, come here. I'll give you one for free.
Pretty much. She acted like she knew the men, giving them an unwanted hug and stole items from their pockets. W, says Chris from Paulton. I'm inclined to agree. In one October incident, Stevens allegedly walked up to a victim and gave the victim a hug while reaching into his back pants pocket. The victim told the Pinellas County Sheriff's Office that after the strange encounter, the victim noticed a credit card was missing from the wallet. The victim had just used the card and said it was in possession of the wallet, which could have been easily accessible. The Sheriff's Office said Stevens allegedly spent nearly $1,000 on the stolen credit card.
Charlie Turk said, oh, she was hugging the block, literally. Ma, I've been hugging the block. That's right. Damn. Hustling rocks.
Damn.
Damn, Ma.
That's not my wallet, Mary, says Khufu. Oh.
Honestly, she did the same thing that those De Claremont twins did, man. Yeah. You wait till you get an old Mark and he falls asleep and you just steal his wallet or his Rolex, man, and leave him for dead.
You know, it's a pretty foolproof method. We used to rate methods back in the day on a scale of 1 to 10. I would say as far as doing a crime goes, this one's pretty high up there.
I like that a lot, man. And honestly, she should extend her range to younger victims, too. She shouldn't just isolate it to old men. Like, you could definitely, because she could have got me. I would have definitely been thinking, like, she's probably just having an old senior moment. Let me give her a hug and, you know, send her on the way so she's all right. And she would have got me for my whole fucking wallet.
If she wanted to get really diabolical, you know who she could have targeted?
Young teens and children.
Yeah.
You're going to stop an old lady from giving them a hug, claiming to know them?
Nah, those V-Bucks are mine now, Timothy.
Right, that's what I was about to say. They probably don't have as much financial capital that entices her.
Yeah,
you know?
For real. 20 years from now, NFT wallet's going to be like those one-owner Cadillacs in the garage, says Laker fan.
Yeah.
All right. Mac10 Max says, Will, missed that entire article. Thanks, Progressive, for advertising like I don't already have insurance. this is a good time to plug. If you have Amazon Prime, you can subscribe to the Mystery School stream for free and not get advertisements shoved down your throat by Twitch and Amazon Incorporated.
You gotta do it. You gotta do it. Consider.
Yeah, consider. Those teens kicked that man in the lake, though, says Mercer. That's true. A Gen Z teen might just windmill kick a grandma in the mall after they muscle their V-Bucks out.
I just want to hug you for your V-Bucks, sonny. Yeah, it could be an assault waiting to happen.
Heartbreak VZ says, we need to snatch purses more. These old ladies be stealing too.
Yeah, I bet old ladies steal more than we think, y'all, because they're never suspected.
Maker Gains, holy shit. You see what Maker Gains said in the chat?
Sub or loosen that throat.
Jesus Christ.
What?
All right, we got to get out of here.
That sounds like prison talk, man. What are you doing?
Computer.
Yo.
Take us home.
Yeah, take me the fuck home. I need to be home immediately after
get
that.
Get me out of here, man.
My last comment that was made.
God. All right, Chad, it's that special, special, special time of night. Do you know what time it is?
No, what time is it? What's going on now?
It's time for Sudden Death. The segment where we make a full song live in under 30 minutes and you choose the topic based off of all of the shit we talked about on the stream tonight. So,
wow.
What's about to happen is we're going to go over all the articles we talked about really quick in like under 60 seconds or so. Keep your favorite three in mind. Let them rock in the chat. The ones that he sees most commonly are going into a poll. You'll vote on that poll. Whichever wins, we're making a full song about live.
That's fucking right, man.
From the top, here's everything we covered tonight. We got the Snickle Pickle.
Snipples.
Rat squeezing, says Distinky Heel.
Rat squeeze freestyle. All right.
We got the Snickers dick vein getting removed.
Remove vein.
Mike Tyson gummy. Remove vein freestyle.
Sorry, some gummy.
Futuristic ass Rolls Royce.
No, there's nothing there.
Respect for the gay dog.
Man, respect all dogs.
Yes. Letting a bat out in the Batman screening.
Now that I can get out with. Letting bat out in movie.
Nice. Squeezing accusations.
Okay, squeezing accusations.
Man accused of animal cruelty after squeezing pet rat inside of fast food restaurant.
Perfect.
Yeah. Oh, we didn't do that one. We got this being sued for the chocolate penis.
The choco cock. No, there's nothing we can do with that one, man. It'll just end up being us making another dick song, man, and not today.
Kango says sounding freestyle. Ani Slime, thank you for that Prime sub. Appreciate that. With the Hermit Grant emoji. We got, No. Please,
no.
Please don't make me talk about this one anymore.
Just no.
Oh, the fucking greatest freestyler of all time.
Political freestyles?
Political rap. Taylor Jane the Great says, I want to see more appearances from River on the stream, please. You got to come to my solo streams for that. She's locked out at the stream studio.
Locked out. For a good reason. I've seen her do several crazy things, like claw at cords.
We did a Goblin Mode freestyle, didn't we?
Yeah, we did that one. We did a Goblin Mode, so we'll leave that one out.
What else do we got? We got, a Lego license.
Oh, okay. All right. We did the Cozy Coop too, not too long ago. But is that the same?
Yeah, I think it's different enough.
All right.
And old ladies doing heinous crime.
Old lady crime.
All right, Chad. All right. Which ones are you feeling? Let us know. I'm going to get Ableton ready. While I'm doing that, he's going to look at the ones you're posting, and we'll get the poll going here.
That's right. We got quite a few options on today's Sudden Depth. Oh, that would be a cool segment where we just suddenly start talking very deep about things and sharing our emotions.
Because when I introduced Sudden Depth, I literally thought to myself, it's crazy that I've never called it Sudden Depth on accident. And you said it later.
Sudden Depth. Yeah.
Wow, guys. You know, you ever really thought about the nature of existence in life?
Just all of a sudden we just give y'all real heavy topics to think about before bed. But not today, goddammit. No. We're doing Sudden Depth. And we got quite a few cool articles here. My favorite so far would be Respect All Dogs. Letting Bat Out in Movie Freestyle. Squeezing Accusation is also real promising to me. And I also love Lego License. And, damn, these are all pretty good, actually. Old Lady Crimes is not bad. Let's see what the chat is saying,
though. What's the chat saying?
They definitely love Old Lady Crimes, so that's one. Old Lady Crimes is one for sure. How do y'all feel about letting a bat out in the movie? Comment on that one in the chat. I'll take the first couple
oddly specific, but I kind of like it.
Nope, nobody really cares about that one. All right, so we'll take Old Lady Crimes as one, and then we got Respect All Dogs. You guys fucking with Respect All Dogs, or is it just me?
It's all right.
Lego License. Okay, I see
I
two people
like
talking
Lego
about
License.
So we got Old Lady Crimes, Old Lady Crimes, and Lego License. Those are two. So we need one more. What's the next most powerful topic we can pick for a night?
Squeeze rat. Squeezing accusations.
Yeah,
is pretty
squeezing
good.
Accusation. That's
yeah,
third.
Because it doesn't have to be squeezing the rat. You just get accused of squeezing all sorts of shit, you know?
Yeah, I've seen it happen, man. So we got Lego License. We have Squeezing Accusation and Old Lady Crimes as today's top three Sudden Death articles. I think we're ready to go, man.
This is going
to
be a chaotic poll, man. I already feel the energy bubbling. Kix is going to get the poll up in just a second here. Please make sure to cast your votes, everyone. You can also use channel points and bits to sway the vote because this isn't a democracy. It's a re-rocracy, all right?
Yeah. Trying to think, do I hate any one of these? Old Lady Crimes, I don't hate that. I don't hate Squeezing Accusations.
I like Squeezing Accusations.
And I don't hate... What's the last one? Lego License. Oh, no, I don't hate any of these. All right. If any of those wins, I'll be happy. It's fine.
Okay.
All right, poll coming up in just a second here. Please make sure to cast your votes. I'm glad that Snickers dick vein wasn't one of the topics tonight.
Yeah, we made it out safe and sound with that one.
A rat stress ball. I still have that object that I showed on stream that was a stress ball the other day, but know where it went.
All right, the poll is up. Make sure you guys cast those votes right now. You got a limited amount of time. And use those channel points and or bits to sway the vote. You know how to do it.
I just casted my vote. City Lifestyle 01. It's their first time gifting a sub in the channel.
Thank you, City Lifestyle. We about to make a fucking song just for you doing that.
Thank you.
It's time to go in.
Thank you very much. Mac10Max asking for the beat sample. I know exactly which one you're talking about. He's referring to this one.
I think I know what it is too.
I don't know if we'll end up using that one.
Who knows, man? I don't know about fist for today.
It's really hard to work with. That's a hard-ass sample.
Yeah, you got to be ready for like a Trippy Red song with that.
Yo, they're actually all really close tonight. This is what we're looking for. There's about 30 seconds left in the poll. Squeezing Accusations is in a tight first place. They're all within percent of each other right now.
Cast those votes, y'all. Use those channel points and bits right now, man. If you want your topic to win, you better pull out all the stops right
now. Yo, they're all neck and neck. They're like all tied right now. Old Lady Lick is slightly in the lead. If you want your topic to win, please cast a vote. Old Lady Lick is now in the lead. There's about 20 seconds left. Lego License is now in the lead.
It's coming down to the wire.
Oh, shit. Lego License is taking off in the last minute here.
What's going to happen?
Old Lady Lick is jockeying for second place.
Squeezing Accusations fell behind. That was in the lead.
Squeezing Accusations, no.
What's going to happen? Where are we going to end up here?
Old Lady Lick has surged. Oh, God, there's seconds left in the poll. What's it going to... Lego License
just jumped to the front. What the fuck is about to happen?
Oh, no.
Lego License.
There's seconds left.
Old Lady Lick.
There's seconds left in the
poll. Who's it going to be? I think it's going to be Old Lady Lick, man.
What's it going
to be? Oh, wait. Lego License just jumped up.
Oh,
shit. Lego License just jumped up at the last second.
Damn.
And pulled out a five-piece, man. That's insane.
Wow.
What the fuck just happened there?
That was the closest poll I think we've ever had on the stream.
Man, dude, Squeezing Accusations was winning at first, and then it just fell behind. We must got some real whales. Oh, the Kringle used 34,000 channel points, and Real Gamer used 297.
Hippie
bits.
Rhetoric says,
I went broke for nothing.
I hate when that happens, man. But luckily, you'll be able to gain more points by watching the stream and gambling.
Yeah, which is the only fair way to do it in this day and age, you know?
You're never out of luck here. We got your back.
All right, well, chat, you know the deal. It's time for sudden death. We told you it's a re-rocracy, not a democracy, so you got to cheat to get ahead in this world. So let's find a Lego License sample tonight?
Lego License.
Okay, I'm just going to scroll weirdly to the middle here and just see what kind of samples we got. No, I gotta go higher up. I wanna see some newer ones, actually. Let me know when you hear it.
Okay. Lego License. What are we feeling for this? That sounds Lego-y.
It's like a Legoland-ass beat.
Not bad,
you like
not
that
bad.
One? Or should I keep going?
Let's keep going. What does it sound like when you get your Lego License?
I like this one too.
Nah. That honestly is the first one that I could say is pretty spot on.
Yeah.
I got my L's, Lego License. From L's.
Okay, that's a good one. L's, all right, let's find one more.
I like that, but not for this. Yes!
Yeah!
That one right there.
Oh!
Ooh.
These are so good tonight.
Actually, oh man. Oh, these are so good shit. Tonight. All right. I don't know how this is about to go. Both of these are really good samples. Yo, what the
this
fuck
is what
is
happens
about to happen here?
When the articles are so good on the stream that we have to force our chat to fight head to head to see what we're gonna do the song about. I know it's gonna be the same way with these samples because these are both very Lego licensee ass samples here.
All
right. That's Kicks, fire. Go ahead and start the poll for the shortest amount of time you can. We're going to have you vote one more time for what sample we're going to use tonight. As soon as the poll comes up, I'm going to start playing them. Do us right, chat. I like both of these a lot.
Please.
It's up to you, okay? It's up to you. Poll coming up in just a second here. This is going to be tough, says Big Bass.
I'm going to send y'all telekinetic messages on my favorite one so you can vote for it.
This is option one right here. Option one.
This fire. Second one's fire.
I'm not mad at either of these. That's option one. And we got option two.
Oh, two is taking off. Two's taking off, man. It's at night. Yeah, two's got way more votes right now. If you guys want one, you better pick up the pace and use those channel points and bits.
Option one right here. Option one.
Damn, this Nintendo Wii ass beat is tight.
Yeah, these are both sick. Number one. And once again, number two. I can't even see the poll.
Two got it, man. Two just took off on a landslide. It's gonna be two.
This is such a Lego license ass beat.
It's two. It's two. Stop the fucking counter. It's two, man. We know what it is. Stop the vote. Number two has won. Sudden Death is underway, man. You guys picked it.
All right, Chad. Let's go. I'm just gonna make sure this is in time real quick, and we're gonna get it started. Here we go. Okay, we are good to go. Sudden Death emotes in the chat, please. You know what the deal is. It's time for Sudden Death. We're about to have 30 minutes on the clock. At the 20-minute mark, it's time for the chat sample. You get to say any sound in the chat that you think goes in the beat. Kix is going to pick it out, send it over to me. If we don't use it effectively, we fail the challenge. At the 10-minute mark, it's time for chat words. You get to pick any three words that go into the beat, go into his verses or hooks. If we fail to add them, we fail Sudden Death for the night. The stakes are high. I don't have a joke to make, so it's time.
Stakes are high, assholes. That's all we got, man.
Timer has begun. All right, let's rock. Let me turn this down.
All right, you know what the topic is? It's Lego license, man. I got my Lego license. Now what can I go do? Can I go to brick-ass Lego strip clubs now? Can I smoke a Lego cigarette? Can I get my Lego dick sucked for free now that I have got my Lego license, man? Y'all let me know in the chat. I think we got quite a monstrous topic on our hands.
Oh, that sounds sick too.
Oh, I like that switch up. That's tight.
It's gonna take some heat off of it.
Oh, I like this. Bricked up in my license pick. Oh, I like that flow. All right, we're good.
Oh, the low one is crazy too.
That's nasty.
Oh, this is a great sample. I'd like to start making more like melodic music during Sudden Death, but sometimes these samples are so good and they fit the topic so well. I love to use them.
All right. This one did it. All right, the bars are already flying in the chat, man. Jaguar Germ. Is this a sample Young Skirt used? And I don't know. We got Bricked Up Building Bricks. Hand me the bag. This is Stick Up. When you go to sleep, I got your chick up. Oh, yeah. Not a plumber, but I stay dripped up.
Oh, SSG Zombie with the 10 gifted.
Let's go, SSG Zombie. Thank you. Welcome back.
Thank you, man. We appreciate it. Good to see you in the chat again. Oh, and then this one's like a roll.
Let's go, man. It's Sudden Death. 27 minutes on the clock tonight, man.
Okay, let's go. Let's try this.
Bricked up in my license pick. I like that. Pick.
Okay. And this was like jute. I say that on stream like every time, and no one knows what I'm talking about.
Bricked up in my license pick. Bricked up in my license. What was the other line? Oh, there was another one. Khufu, thank you for that bar anyway. I'm going to try to figure this out. 27 on the clock. Lego license is the topic tonight, man. It's the fucking Lego license, man. What are you doing when you get your Lego license? You going to the brick strip clubs? The brick club? Brip club? Put them in the license picks. Put them in the license picks.
Okay, cool. You want a clap or a snare?
Let's do a... Oh, I like that snare. Yeah, keep that.
Okay, yeah, I like that one too.
That shit is perfect.
Okay. Yep, okay.
Got pulled over by the Popo with the Draco in the back with the Lego pack. Lego pack. Okay, I like that. Doing donuts in the pickup. Legoland away that I whip the bricks up. Oh, Young General is so sliding.
I want the duck duck.
I bricked up in a license pick. Shorty bad and she liked the drip. Up in a license pick. Shorty bad and she liked the drip. Oh, you going crazy already, bro.
Thanks, dude.
That little.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's tight.
I hear something else.
I'm honestly a big fan of this beat right now. This one is coming out crazy. This one, I definitely was like, damn, I wish I could have rapped to this in real life. This is going nuts.
I'm going to do like an alternation between these two. So the first one's like, and then the second one's like.
This is pitch. Ooh. Yeah, get him. 25 minutes on the clock. This is sudden death.
Oh, that's what I was looking for. I want this one too.
All right, I'm back in the chat looking for some good bars. What we got? Swerving in Lego Batmobile. Okay. Lego Island pizza delivery to a guy in jail. Oh, I like that. What?
Yeah, shout out Lego Island. We need some Lego Island bars in here.
Batmobile, guy in jail. Okay. I like that.
All right, we need the 808.
24 minutes on the clock.
I already hear it.
Picked up in white space.
That's it right there.
I can never spend a night in jail. Just now tuning in, this is Sudden Death, where we make a song live from scratch in under 30 minutes. This is the part of the stream where we mumble into the microphone and write the raps and make the beat like my friend here is doing. You see the timer at the top of the screen. If we don't finish this song before that runs out, then we both will get attacked by feral dogs outside of this very door right here. We gotta watch out. Bricked up in the license pit. Shitty bad that you like the drip. I can never spend a night in jail. Stack another brick, yeah, might as well. Okay.
That's it right hard. There.
Might as well. Where am I? Boy looks sweeter than Ric Flair. Every day wake up and change my hair. Whoa, damn, Maker Games.
Oh, they got Lego bars right now, right?
Yes.
Oh, God. This is going to be a good
big,
one.
Big change my hair bars by taking off your Lego helmet and switching it with another hairstyle.
Okay. Oh, this last one's gonna be like, hi.
Here, look.
Oh, this is kind of going in already tonight.
Oh,
Okay, hold on. We need a kick.
My hair look wet. My hair look wet. Looks hard. I'll snap it off.
Okay. Oh, shit.
That's a good bar. My hair look wet. Look hard. I'll snap it off.
Wait, boom, boom. Yeah, that's the kick. Okay. This beat is knocking already. I'm feeling good about this one.
Okay. 21 minutes on the clock, not too bad. Bars is coming out okay. I'm not super slow today. Making some moves.
One other
license for building Legos. Now I can hit the corner store to buy some cigarillos.
One other percussion to layer under the snare here. It's a little sharp.
You
like how shitty the snare is?
Love it.
That 808 is hitting tonight.
This shit is riding, I ain't gonna lie.
Thanks, man.
Nah, this shit fire. Young Lego don't need no Botox. My bitch built like a Roblox. General Soul going nuts.
Oh, okay. I'm going to start organizing it. I know the chat sample's coming up. I don't think I need much more on this. This is actually knocking at the moment.
Sudden death.
Oh God, it's that special time where I gotta pull in the chat sample on behalf of Kicks the Flare. Kicks, thank you for handling this for us, man. Oh, I think I know what this one's gonna be. I see the clue.
What's tonight's sample?
Okay, we got the chat sample locked and loaded here. Let me drag this in and take a listen to it. Yes.
That's it.
Yes.
All right. I don't know what the fuck that was.
It's like the Lego building sound from Legoland.
Oh, got it. Okay.
I'm going to try to make that like an effect. This part. That's actually crazy. I can use like a transient shaper on this. Okay. I'm going to work on that for just a second here.
Busting Duplo. That's big bricks. And I'm advanced with work. Pushing the techniques. Realm. Oh, we got Lego Brick Architect with Arctic Shark Marksmanship. Mick Raiden with the wordplay. Damn.
I feel
Lego
like
Lego Brick Architect with Arctic Shark Marksmanship. Damn.
I feel like our chatters have gotten better at their lyrics from Sudden Death, too.
For real.
Can we get a one in the chat if you feel like your lyrical ability has improved from watching or participating in Sudden Death?
Yeah.
Because that's a one for me, even.
I love when the non-writers and lyricists contribute by just throwing in, like, the subject matter, too. Like, throw in, like, relevant topics and subject matter. You don't got to be a rapper or a rhymer to assist with this. Yeah. Sometimes it's just a random idea that goes with the subject matter that'll really help.
I totally agreed. I'm going to turn this into, like, a effect.
18 minutes on the clock. Time is ticking.
And then we just need some delay. Let's try Echo Boy. What a great plugin. Sound Toy, sponsor the stream. Please. Ping Pong. Yep, great effect right there. I might be able to use that as like a shaker or something if I put like an LFO tool on it.
Oh, fun fact for the Ableton heads here. A lot of producers have started doing this shit. But if you change the warping mode to beats and you change it to transients and you bring it down, or you change it to like 16ths or something, you can do this. Let me see. Oh, that actually kind of did turn into a shaker. All right, I'm spending too much time on the sample, but the beat's pretty much done, so it's fine.
Okay.
Where's my LFO tool? I got time today. Yep, that's what I was looking for.
All right, I got to move on to this hook. What's it going to be? Lego, okay.
Boom. Okay, so we got this nice shaker now. Here, listen to the swing on that. That's pretty nice, actually.
That's tight.
Okay. Sounds like wet clicking for now, but it's fine.
Bray. What am I going to do for a hook here? 16 minutes. 16 on the clock.
Okay, I'm gonna put that in for the hook probably later.
All right, nice. Let's see what we got here.
All right, keep organizing the beat here. Keep things moving.
Hey, can't take my pants off without my legs. Okay, I like that.
Shit drops out. Oh yeah, and then the last part's like ding ding.
Fuck, I am having a little trouble. I can't put together what this second verse is about. Listen, I thumb through a grip and put my thumb on a brick. Outcast 89, you going crazy? Doing donuts in a pickup, not Legoland, but I'm with the bricks up. I like that.
Yeah. Okay, and then the hook hits right there. Boom. I love that shitty snare.
That snare is hot. I got my hair clipped onto my head. Can't take my pants off without my legs.
This shit is actually pretty much done. I kind of speed ran this beat tonight.
My pieces.
All right. Symbol tonight for sure.
I got.
Ooh, that sounded cool. That's in my head. Sorry, I zoned out, Chad. My bad. I was just vibing. Oh. Let's do this guy then.
Okay, 12 minutes on the clock. I am actually way behind.
I'm pretty much done. I'll set the beat loop for you.
Oh, yeah, just loop that, and I can knock these bars out. This is sudden death. 12 minutes left on the clock. Yeah. I got my hands.
Sudden death, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. We gotta start recording soon. Chat words coming up in 2 minutes. Get some good ones going. Take the West suggest for the hook. Stacking bricks got me whips. Legoland, I'm taking trips.
Alright,
that's pretty good.
It might be a consideration right there. Let's see.
This beat is here. Farting tonight.
Little plink. Mask on like a bionicle. Doing old lady crimes with Professor McGonagall.
Oh, shit.
Bionicle, that's it, too. I love bionicles. Classic square. She threw it in a circle. Ari Flux, let's go.
That's what I was forgetting. Generic risers. Let me look for that real quick.
Oh, I just saw something crazy that I needed to write. Where'd it go? Where'd it go?
Brick Squad!
Wow. That's what we needed right there.
I actually missed that one. I'm going to throw that in.
Real Lex Luger vibes.
Chat words.
It's time
we
got to
start
words.
Recording.
Yep. What will they be today? I am so behind on these bars. I don't know why I'm not fucking connecting these raps, but maybe these chat words will help me out. Looks like today they're Patterson, Tetris, and Steppin. Patterson. All right. Let's see what this is all about.
You want auto-tune?
Let's
see how it sounds.
I don't think I need it just yet.
I don't think we need it.
Patterson, Tetris, and Steppin. Okay. Tetris. And let's go.
Missed a gifted sub from Ice Cream Lord. Ice Cream Lord, thank you, man.
All right, let me see here. Lego Enthusiast, license to build. Oh, God. All right, play with my coins. Pop your head off. Everything you do is with desktop. I love that. Let's see. Lego, it's Batmobile.
Oh, and I need to build and roll. Yes. Right before each drop.
Let me self-defense you. Hold me. I need a hook.
All right.
Okay. Let me see.
We got 9 minutes. Alright, 8 minutes.
Alright, hold on. Let me get this hook, because this is the first time I didn't even have a hook before the second verse, so let me see.
Pattinson. Laker fan, what the fuck? What are those bars? Put one in your head, that's a mindstorm? Oh.
I'm upset I never get to see the bars because I'm making the beat. I'm a brick marble, they call me Iron Man. BKW, thank you, man.
All right. Let's get it, man.
There you go.
I don't have anything here, but
it's cool.
Let's pray to the gods that we can come up with something.
You
man.
Warmed up during Freestyle Friday today.
I think so, man. Hopefully this freestyle can take me where I need to go.
All right, so you're going to come in here.
All right, let's do it. That should be good.
All right, here you go. Coming in.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Che. Bricked up with my license pick. Got L's, but they're not legit. Shorty bad and she like the drip. Couple keys that I like to flip, yeah. I could never spend a night in jail. Stack another brick, might as well. My hair look wet and sapped. Damn.
Right, I'll bring you a little closer in.
Yeah,
here you go. Come closer. In.
Bricked up. Oh.
Right here. That.
One, two. Bricked up with my license pick. Got L's, but they're not legit. Shorty bad and she like the drip. Couple keys that I like to flip. I can spin up.
Got you. Coming in same place.
Same spot. 6 minutes on the clock. This is sudden death. Yeah. Bricked up with my license pick. Got L's but they're not legit. Shorty bad and she like the drip. Couple keys that I like to flip. I can never spend a night in jail. Stack another brick, yeah, I might as well. My hair look wet, look hard, I snap it off. No sweat, I'm good, I'm plastic, y'all. My bitch don't need no Botox. Square as hell like Roblox. Patterson told me to stop, but I told him I don't need the block. Stacking bricks like Tetris. You feel me? I'm doing my metrics. Stretching it like I'm stretching shit. And they all plastic. At the top of the stairs, I leave the crumbs. And if your dad step, he might hurt his foot and his thumb. That's an ass catch. I ain't no catch him. Never. Ah, God, dude.
Dude, you almost at the finish line. Almost at the finish line there.
I have no bars today.
Hold on. It's fine. It's fine.
I have no bars.
You were going to get there.
What the fuck, man?
Hold on. Let me just make sure this is in time here.
Oh, my God. I'm struggling. Feel me? I'm doing my metrics. Stretching it like I'm stretching shit. And they all plastic. At the top of the stairs, I leave the crumbs. And if your dad step, he might hurt his foot and his thumb. Ass catch.
What do you think?
Yeah, maybe after thumb or something like thumb. That. Stretching it like I'm stretching. At the top of the stairs, I leave the crumbs. Hey, right there, right there, right there.
Leave the crumbs?
Yeah, maybe after crumbs. All right.
Okay, I got you. Coming in a little bit before that.
Okay.
Here we go.
Stacking bricks like Tetris. Feel me? I'm doing my metrics. Stretching it like I'm stretching shit. And they all plastic. At the top of the stairs, I leave the crumbs. I seen him. Your dad stepped on him. And then I seen him leaning. Tried to grab onto the rail. And he fell down. He said, oh, hell, that shit hurt. That shit worked. I'm about to whoop your ass in church.
Oh, yeah, that's Lego bars.
That's good Lego
that's
bars,
Lego
right,
bars
there.
Right there.
All right. Fucking with it. Fucking with okay. it. See how this hook is going to go. God, I don't know why I couldn't come up with nothing fast enough tonight.
Let me get this. The right volume here. Beat is farting too loud tonight. All right, coming in before the hook.
Okay.
Here you go. Coming in.
Tried to grab onto the rail and he fell down. He said, oh, hell, that shit hurt. That shit worked. I'm about to whoop your ass in church. Okay, one more time. Sorry. You can start me closer.
Okay, coming in. Half as close.
Yep. Hell, that shit hurt. That shit worked. I'm about to whoop your ass
they
in church.
They got me blocked in, blocked out. Running when the cops out. Moving round and round and round. I just need to stop. I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks. It's me they trying to stop.
Yes, double that.
Double that up. Double hook that. There. All right. That's the Lego license. That makes sense. All right.
Church would be the worst place to get your ass whooped, says Nidius.
Yeah, you left those Legos on the stairs last night. Dad's whooping that ass,
yeah,
man.
He's not pleased about this. All right, let me just duplicate this guy here, and we are into the second verse. The chaotic raw freestyle. Okay, here we go.
Let's do it.
Coming in halfway through the hook.
or last four bars of the hook, rather. Here we go.
I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks.
Yeah.
I just need the blocks.
Hey.
It's me they trying to stop.
I got my hair clipped onto my head. Can't take my pants off without my legs. Leave bricks on bricks. Heard what I said. I need them legs laying on my bed. You a bionicle. That mean you wear a mask when I seen you. You ain't even trying to spree through. You ain't even gonna breeze through.
Damn. And he sneezed. Everybody on their knee. Fuck.
Oh, the flow was crazy. The flow was crazy. You want me to start you over again or punch?
Start it over. Start it over. Okay. Start it over.
I got you. Here we go. Coming in.
I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks.
Yeah.
I just need the blocks. It's me they trying to stop.
I got my hair clipped onto my head. Can't take my pants off without my legs. Leave bricks on bricks. Heard what I said. I need them legs laying on my bed. You're bionicle. You a moronic dude. Seen you stepping, but you didn't get my blessing. Damn, stack it up. I just tried to get more. Cops pulling me over, and my license is 4. It's years old, that's when I got it. I was 4 coming in for profit, eating some of them M&Ms, and then I tried them Timberlands on my feet. Trying to smoke up my weed, and I see that you stole my high C. Don't bite me. Click it in, Lego style. With the Star Wars fucking on that turnstile.
Oh, damn it.
Couldn't connect it. No.
Oh, dude, you're almost there.
Cut the end. And I could punch. I could punch somewhere in there.
I got you. Hold
on. Oh, my brain. Oh, God. I cannot make it connect things. Man. Don't bite me. Click it in. Lego style. With the Star Wars.
You click it in Lego style?
Yeah. Maybe Lego style.
Okay,
yeah,
you said.
That you stole my high seat. Don't bite me. Click it in. Lego style.
Okay. Good.
Yeah, that should be it.
Okay, coming in right now. Here we go.
And I see that you stole my high seat. Don't bite me. Click it in. Lego style. Spare no child.
Yeah. They got me.
Oh, shit. Wow.
Spare no child.
Take a dark turn.
All right. Well, that's what I got. That's what I got for today. Hopefully this works. God,
yeah,
I need
works.
To. My freestyle brain is, damn. I thought it would be better after doing freestyle,
dude,
Friday, but it's worse.
I think this is about as much as you can expect from the fucking Lego license freestyle. Stop the clock.
Yeah, there it is. At least we didn't fail it.
Hey,
didn't fail it. All
we
right,
did it. It's the gibberish raps. Yeah, I was finishing on the gibberish raps as the palate cleanser that twisted all your wires around.
It definitely twisted my brain up.
Damn.
I just literally can't fucking think. But. I think it's acceptable.
Yes,
it
worked out, man. I'm very pleased with the outcome of this.
I'll accept it.
Chat,
I'll accept that.
If you tuned in late, you're wondering what the hell you just saw. This was a segment called Sudden Death. We made this entire song live in under 30 minutes, and you chose the topic based off the news that we covered on the stream tonight. Tonight's article for Sudden Death came from alleged stoner stopped after wild car chase whips out license from Legoland. They voted for the Lego license freestyle on the stream tonight, and of course, we had to acquiesce.
We had to. Yeah, shit came out hard, though, man.
Yeah.
Sounds fucking great.
I'm actually
great.
Very pleased with that.
Yeah, I like it. Well, I guess that's the end of our streams for this week.
It is.
Another week down, man. How you guys feeling? You survived. You're living another week, living through another Mystery School stream.
If you enjoyed the week of Mystery School streams this week, can we get some union emotes in the chat, please? I, for one, had a great time this week. We were on the front page on Monday. Wednesday, we did the podcast stream. We hit a sudden death tonight. The articles were on fire. I'm feeling good about where the Mystery School stream's at right now. And we're regularly doing research and development outside of the stream to keep taking things to the next level. So we're working on some shit.
R&D. You got it.
All right. So here's what's about to happen. We're going to thank tonight's gifters, of which there were many. Thank you all very much for the contributions tonight.
Yes, beautiful gifters
tonight. Then we are going to find someone in the music section of Twitch with 1 or 0 viewers to raid. We know that it's late. If you got to go to bed, we totally understand. But we would really appreciate it if you'd stick around. It's really hard to stream on Twitch, and it's harder to stream music content on Twitch. So last time, I think we almost made a guy cry by raiding him. It was his first time on Twitch, zero followers, zero viewers.
And he was talented as shit, man. He was great, man. Great voice, great guitar skills, man. What a good night.
Oh, yeah, Kix clarified it was a good cry, not like, hey, you fucker. It's like bullied him to tears. It was actually a...
bullied him to tears. No, that's tight, man. The effect that you guys have on people is miraculous. So keep it up, man. We just want to raid people with one or less viewers and, you know, try to just get them started on their musical stream career because, like he said, it is hard.
And who's Outcast in the chat said, play the song back right before we start the raid. We're going to play the track one more time as the outro. So if you'd like to hear that, stick around, please. We'd appreciate it. And, of course, if you're not in the Mystery School Discord, consider joining by heading to this link or typing ?Discord in the chat. Every single article we talk about on the stream is posted in the stream news section, and we need your help now more than ever during bleak times in the world to find funny, weird, strange shit to talk about. It doesn't have to be an article. It can be a meme. It can be a tweet. It can be some weird shit you found on the internet. Just
something you found on the ground. Yeah. You can just bring it to us. If it makes like logical sense to read it, then we'll read it. We like anything. Just bring us something new. Yeah. It doesn't matter what it is. We just like to see it.
Show us something cool. So real quick, before we start looking for someone to raid here, I want to thank tonight's gifters. We got Ice Cream Lord with a gifted sub, SSG Zombie with 10 gifted subs. We got City Style with one, Dumob with two.
Let's go.
SSG Zombie with another several tonight. Hippie Rhetoric with one, Megan Maxine with 10 gifted subs. Thank you, Megan. We appreciate you. Nasilla with a sub, Nash Attack with 5 gifted. Tommy Chishido with a new sub, Chubsy Wubsy with one, Kicks Before with one. I think 6 today. Charlie Torque with 1. Dumob with 5. Kix with 5. Great Dane 22 with 5. Megan Maxine with 5. More Mobs with 5 gifted subs. In Love We Trust with 5 gifted subs. Young General Soul with 5. Kicking it off.
Wow. Thank you, everyone. What a great week, man. Appreciate y'all unlocking this sudden death here tonight and supporting our earlier Freestyle Friday tonight. I definitely was happy delivering those gibberish bars to you guys, man. But I think they robbed my brain of intelligence after some point, man.
Yeah.
It's so hard to come back. But tonight's sudden death was one for the books, man. I really like this beat, and the subject matter was crazy tonight. So we thank you guys for contributing.
All right. The Nash Attack said, a bitch got paid. Nash Attack, thank you very much. All the gifters, seriously, we appreciate everyone who decides to gift subs or donate or sub to the stream. It really means a lot. But, like, not to get all sappy on you, the thing that means the most to us is that you guys keep showing up to witness this depravity. That's truly supporting the stream the most. And we really appreciate all of our core viewers that have helped us grow the channel over the last couple of years. I don't know what the fuck we'd be doing without
you guys. You guys support now. It helps us to... it helps us to employ our friends on the stream and it helps us support them. So all the sub revenue that we get, it goes to just
putting back into the pocket of
our helpers. Everybody's helping us with the stream, man. Our friends that are behind the scenes doing the X's and O's, man. Mm-hmm. So you guys are supporting a good cause, man. It's not even for us. It's just to fucking like, you know, help us get some help and pay the people that are doing good shit with us. So thank you guys for helping us build a better machine here.
Yes, it really means a lot to us, everyone. Thank you so much. All right, so we're going to start to get the hell out of here, but not after we find a raid first. If you can stick around, we'd really appreciate it. We know that it's late. Watching TikTok Come See Me, a literal child.
Literal child. Nope. That is not what we're going to do today.
Fun with bass, says Sir Bomb Grips. What the hell's going on here?
It looks like a personal like fight. Are they just fighting in a room together?
I don't know if I can click that. Here, let's see what this guy's doing over
here.
Sir Bomb Grips. I peeped you, Bomb Grip. All right, sitting in an echoey room, just vibing out.
All right, we'll keep it moving and see if we can find something a little bit more
high production value
right now. But he's there.
Live from the Super Coop.
It was some dude that looked like he was in Second Life. I don't know if he's a real person.
Yeah. It's kind of weird hearing myself.
Freestyle rapper.
Is he live?
Yes.
Talk to him. Let's say hi. Let's see if he says something. Hurry, hurry, hurry. Before he looks away. All right. Respond.
He's going to see it. He's got his chat on screen. Oh, he muted himself on accident.
Tell him he's mute.
Oh,
okay, he came back.
Dude, I just got a good vibe from this guy. I feel very strong.
I think he'll give us what we want for tonight, man.
Oh, that's
He looks like he's in some form of hell right now, and he's about to give us live freestyles. I'm with it. I like this.
What do you want? What do you want, chat? You want this to be the raid? I think this is our best bet, frankly.
I think this is probably what we need, man. This is what the Mystery School needs on a Friday night, yeah. Man.
Dude, it's Friday. Yeah, buddy is peaking, says Baker Games.
Yeah, he's peaking in hell right now. Let's give him a shot. I think he's just demonic enough to really let us off on a Friday night.
BRB, man. All right, I just told him we'll be right back. His username is Super Chicken. I got a good vibe.
Yeah, he's fucking confusing, man. This is about to be tight. I like the sound of this guy.
I got it. I got it.
Rat shirt, too. He got a rat shirt on. Let's go.
He's got a sloth shirt.
Rat shirt.
Same difference. Yo, Heartbreak VZ, thank you for the 11-month Prime resub, man.
Let's go, VZ.
All right. All right. We are going to start getting the hell out of here. Thank you for such a great week, everyone. We're not sure if we're going to be on the front page on Monday. Sometimes they just kind of surprise us and put us on the front page. So
surprise!
Come protect us either way.
30,000 people yelling at you. And yeah, it just happens like that. But like he said, regardless, come show up and help us defend ourselves on Monday if we are on the front page. And if not, just come through and just coddle us anyway because we're children. Boy child.
Maker Gain says, do not ruin his trip. Yes, everyone, we do these raids to be nice to people. If you're not feeling the vibe, please just leave as opposed to being rude or mean. Okay?
Rich Homie Dose said, his shit kicking in right now. His shit is kicking in, and y'all better go there and fucking encourage him. Yeah. Don't harass him and scare him and say, nightmare, 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 nightmare. You're tripping. Devil, devil, devil. Don't do that. Go in there and talk to him. Have
like,
him freestyle and joke around with the guy, man.
Oh, my man. Excellent rhymes. Yeah,
he
tell
seems
him that.
Like a cool dude. Like, he's in there. I've peaked before. You know, everybody's peaked at one point in time.
Kango said, nightmare, nightmare, nightmare in the chair.
Everybody's worn a hoodie on their head at one point in time and freestyled into the void. Mm-hmm. So don't judge him and just have some fun. He looks like he's there for the good times, man.
Have some fun, everyone. All right. Thank you again for all the gifted subs tonight, everyone, and the encouragement and support. It means a lot to us. We will see you on the Monday stream. We are live Monday, Wednesday, Friday nights, 9 p.m. Central to midnight, right here on the Mystery School stream.
Saying Discord. Nightmare in the chat. Nightmare, 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 and throw
Hop
baby.
In the freaking Discord and post All some right. news for the Monday stream by typing ?Discord in the chat or clicking the links below. Oh, also, I haven't plugged this in a while. All of our VODs get uploaded immediately after the stream to our YouTube channel. It's linked right below. If you want to rewatch any stream, we don't host them on Twitch. Every single one is on our YouTube, our VOD YouTube channel. So if you're looking for those, they're over there. So I'll be uploading that like as soon as we get offline. We're going to play the song one more time, start the raid, and get the hell out of here. Have a great rest of your night, everyone.
Let's go.
Have a great weekend. Stay safe, stay healthy. We'll see you on Monday. We love you. Peace out.
Peace out.
Peace out, y'all. Show our new
sudden death. Yeah. Bricked up in my license pit. Got L's but they're not legit. Shorty bad and she like the drip. Couple keys that I like to flip. I can never spend a night in jail. Stack another brick, yeah, I might as well. My hair look wet, look hard, I snap it off. No sweat, I'm good, I'm plastic, y'all. My bitch don't need no Botox. Square as hell like Roblox. Patterson told me to stop, but I told him I don't need the block. Stacking bricks like Tetris. Feel me, I'm doing my metrics, stretching it like I'm stretching shit, and they all plastic, at the top of the stairs I leave the crumbs, I seen him, your dad stepped on him, and then I seen him leaning, tried to grab onto the rail, and he fell down, and he said, oh hell, that shit hurt, that shit worked, I'm about to whoop your ass
they
in church.
They got me locked in, locked out, running when the cops out, moving round and round and round, I just need to stop, I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks, I just need the blocks. It's me they tryna stop. Be blocked in, blocked out. Running when the cops out. Moving round and round and round. I just need to stop. I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks.
Yeah.
I just need the blocks. It's me they tryna stop.
I got my hair clipped onto my head. Can't take my pants off without my legs. Leave bricks on bricks, heard what I said. I need them legs laying on my bed. Bionicle. You a moronic dude, seen you stepping, but you didn't get my blessing. Damn, stack it up, I just tried to get more. Cops pulling me over and my license is 4.
years old, that's when I got it. I was 4 coming in for profit, eating some of the M&Ms, and then I tried them Timberlands on my feet, trying to smoke up my weed and icy. That you stole my high seat, don't bite me. Click it in, Lego style. Spare no child.
Yeah.
They got me blocked in, blocked out. Running when the cops out. Moving round and round and round. I just need to stop. I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks. It's me they trying to stop. Be blocked in, blocked out. Running when the cops out. Moving round and round and round. I just need to stop. I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks. I just need the blocks. It's me they trying to stop.
All right, everyone, have a great rest of your night and a great weekend. Please stick around for the raid.
Yes, stick around. Show our new friend some love. He's cool. He's freestyling in the dark over there, man. Give him some bars and have some fun. We'll see y'all on Monday. Same time, same place.
Spare no child.
That's right. Spare none. None of them.
All right, everyone. We'll see you then. We love you. Peace.
Peace, peace, peace.